So everyone, welcome after the lunch. Now we will be starting with the another presentation, which is of Moina Group. So basically, we have a center which is nearby here, which is called M-Word Learning Center. So there are some few teachers from there. So they have started the work here, and they have actually established the locality, lab kind of center. So they will be coming here, and they will be talking about maintenance of the Moina. And how are they maintaining? How are they studying the habit and habitat studies? Okay, yeah. Tuba, yeah. Come, come. Come on.
हेलो
बस तोड़ना मत अब
हाय हाय फ्रेंड्स, थोड़ा सा एम वॉर्ड जो जगह अभी आप लोग टीचर्स बताने वाले हैं उसका थोड़ा सा आपको बैकग्राउंड दे देते हैं कि एम वॉर्ड जो आप जानते हैं कि मुंबई डिफरेंट वार्ड्स में बटा हुआ है, तो ये एम वॉर्ड है। बट एम एम वॉर्ड जो है वो मुंबई के सबसे वल्नरेबल वार्ड में से है। तो वल्नरेबल इन टर्म्स ऑफ हेल्थ, एजुकेशन, एस्पिरेशन, एवरीथिंग। तो हमारी कोशिश है, हम TISS से हैं, उसमें एक प्रोजेक्ट है ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग एम वॉर्ड। तो हमारी एक कोशिश है कि किस तरीके से हम उनका एक 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 ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन लेकर आ जाएं। जैसे सैनिटेशन की बात होती है तो वाटर्स को लेके, टॉयलेट्स को लेकर, या फिर एजुकेशन है तो किस तरीके से हम हेल्प कर सकते हैं। तो मोस्टली एम वॉर्ड में BMC स्कूल्स हैं, लेकिन एजुकेशन जो है आप जानते ही होंगे कि किस तरीके से थोड़ा सा चैलेंजिंग है। तो जो टीचर्स हैं हमारे, वो एक ऐसे एरिया से आते हैं, एरिया में पढ़ाते हैं जो जो एम वार्ड में है। तो बेसिकली एम वार्ड बहुत बड़ा है, और इस वल्नरेबल वार्ड में कुछ ऐसे इलाके जो हैं वो जो बहुत ज़्यादा चैलेंजेस फेस करते हैं इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, वाटर, पानी खरीद के पीना पड़ता है। आप सोच लीजिए कि कितना प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है। हमें 1000 गैलन वाटर जो है 3 रुपये में मिलता है, वो 1 गैलन वाटर 7 रुपीज़ में खरीदते हैं। तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि कितना ज़्यादा चैलेंजेस है। तो हमने एक सर्वे किया था, उससे ये पता चला कि कहाँ कहाँ सबसे ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम्स हो रहे हैं। तो उस जगहों पर BMC स्कूल के हिसाब से हमने स्टडी सेंटर बनाए, ताकि वो BMC स्कूल्स को ब्रिज कर दें, एक सपोर्ट दें, उन बच्चों को सपोर्ट दें जो ड्रॉप आउट्स हो जाते हैं, स्कूल छोड़ देते हैं किसी वजह से। थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड में गए हैं और वो ड्रॉप आउट हो गए हैं, एंड देन फिर वो फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड में आते हैं, तो क्या कर सकते हैं हम उनको। तो ये वो बच्चे जो हैं फर्स्ट स्टडी सेंटर में इनरोल होते हैं, एंड देन उनको बेसिक सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड करते हैं टीचर्स, एंड देन उनको पढ़ाने की कोशिश करते हैं, उनसे इंगेज करते हैं, और उनको री इनरोल करते हैं BMC स्कूल्स में। तो ऐसे 5 हमारे स्टडी सेंटर्स हैं। तो वो स्टडी सेंटर्स के 3 स्टडी सेंटर के टीचर्स यहाँ पर हैं, और वो कुछ महीने से हमारे क्यूब के साथ जुड़े हुए हैं, तो वो अपना डेटा प्रेजेंट करना चाहते हैं।
हेलो, मैं महरोज हूँ। जो हमारा स्टडी सेंटर है वो 5 जगहों पे चलता है। एक जनता नगर में है जो कि मानखुर्द के एरिया में है। मैं वहाँ से हूँ।
मेरा नाम नसीबुन्निसा है और मैं वहाँ की टीचर हूँ।
माई नेम इज़ नूर सबा।
माई नेम इज़ सुमेरा।
माई नेम इज़ बिंदु, और मैं भीमनगर में टीचर पढ़ती
हूँ। जब हमने क्यूब का नाम सुना था ना फर्स्ट टाइम, तो हमारे माइंड में क्वेश्चन था कि ये क्यूब आखिर है क्या और करता क्या है। लेकिन जब इससे जुड़े और इसके साथ काम किया ना, तो समझ में आया कि एक्चुअल में एक ऐसी जगह हमें प्रोवाइड करता है जहाँ पर हम साइंस के बड़े बड़े एक्सपेरिमेंट आसानी से, छोटे छोटे एक्सपेरिमेंट कर सकते हैं। लाइक हमें बड़े बड़े लैब की ज़रूरत नहीं है। ज़रूरी नहीं है कि मैं लैब में ही जाके करूँ, या फिर साइंस के बड़े बड़े टूल्स की ज़रूरत हो, बल्कि उसे मैं अपने घर में आसानी से कर सकती, या फिर हम अपने सेंटर पर मोस्ट ऑफ करते हैं।
साइंस जब हम लोग पढ़ते थे हमें लगता था कि साइंस बहुत ज़्यादा बहुत बड़ा है, हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन जब क्यूब में है तो पता चला हम छोटी चीज़ में भी एक्सपेरिमेंट कर सकते हैं। जैसे डायनासोर को ना लेते हुए हमने मोइना लिया, मोइना पे एक्सपेरिमेंट किया, क्यूब के ज़रिए हमें छोटी सी चीज़ पर एक्सपेरिमेंट करने मिला जो आसानी से हमें मिल जाता है।
ऐसी चीज़ें जैसे मोइना, ऐसी चीज़ें जो हमें आसानी से मिलती है और कम पैसों में मिलती है, जिसके लिए हमें कोई पर्टिकुलर जगह की ज़रूरत नहीं है, हम कहीं भी कभी भी और किसी वक्त भी सर्च या प्रैक्टिकल कर सकते हैं।
मोइना को कल्चरिंग करने के लिए ज़रूरी नहीं था कि हम अपने लैब में ही रखें या फिर कोई ऐसा पर्टिकुलर स्पेस जहाँ पर हम उसको रखें, उसे तो हम कहीं पर भी रख सकते हैं। तो हमने अपने सेंटर से शुरुआत की थी और अपने घर पर भी।
ये हमारे अंदर एक क्यूरियोसिटी बढ़ाता है, एक जिज्ञासा बढ़ाता है कि हम सोचने पे मजबूर करता है कि आखिर ये चीज़ है क्या। आसपास में कोई भी चीज़ हम लोग उड़ता देखते हैं, ये नॉर्मली है, कुछ भी भटकता हो देखेंगे, उस पर नोटिस नहीं किया जाता है। लेकिन अगर हम ऐसे सोचने मजबूर है कि आखिर ये है क्या, हाँ, और इसकी फ़ीचर्स क्या है, इसके बारे में हम पता करें क्यों क्या है, क्यों है, कैसे है, और ये सारी वजह से इनके सारे आंसर सब कुछ हम पता कर सकते हैं।
क्यूब से जुड़ने के बाद ही ये समझ में आया कि हर एक चीज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट है। मतलब कि कभी हम लोगों ने ध्यान नहीं दिया हाउस फ्लाई के ऊपर कि वो उसका फंक्शन क्या है, लेकिन जब मोइना पे एक्सपेरिमेंट किया तो दूसरी चीज़ों में भी इंटरेस्ट पैदा होने लगे।
तुम्हारा ही है, बोलो।
फिर हमने एक सेटअप ऑर्गेनाइज किया जो कि मोइना का था। मोइना के ऊपर हमने एक्सपेरिमेंट शुरू किया था। हमारा एम था कि हम ये जान सके मोइना कि लाइफ साइकिल क्या है या फिर मोइना किस तरह ग्रो करता है।
हम ये जानना चाहते थे कि क्या मोइना भी हमारी तरह ऑक्सीजन के साथ हवा के साथ ऑक्सीजन लेता है और हमारी तरह ही ऑक्सीजन के साथ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड को प्रोड्यूस करता है। ये हम इसमें जानना चाहते थे।
हमने जब एक्सपेरिमेंट किया मोइना के ऊपर तो हमने ये ऑब्ज़र्व किया कि जो मोइना है वो काफ़ी ह्यूमन बॉडी से काफ़ी सिमिलर रखता है, जैसे रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, वो भी जैसे हम सांस लेते हैं सांस छोड़ते हैं वो भी सांस लेता है और छोड़ता है, और अगर उसे ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिलता तो वो रेड हो जाए, जैसे हम कभी बहुत ज़्यादा भागते हैं और फिर रुकते हैं तो हम बहुत रेड हो जाते, वैसे मोइना को भी ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिलता तो वो रेड हो जाता है।
और हमें ये भी जानना था कि मोइना की लाइफ साइकिल क्या है, प्लस कि वो बेबीज़ कितने बॉर्न करता है एक वक्त में, और उनका जो प्रीनेटल पीरियड जो होता है डेवलपमेंट का वो कितने लंबे का होता, कितने समय का होता है। इसके लिए हमने फर्स्ट सेटअप बिठाया था जो कि 21 जून से स्टार्ट किया था हमने। हर एक ने दो दो बॉटल ली थी, टोटल 8 बॉटल्स थी और हर बॉटल सेम साइज़ की थी, 500 ml की थी, जिसे हमने हाफ डीसी वाटर 250 ml फिल किया था और सभी ने उसके अंदर 5-5 moina डाले थे, लेकिन मैंने दो बॉटल जो उसमें से अलग कर दी थी और उसके अंदर एक बॉटल के अंदर 6 moina थे और एक के अंदर 2 थे। वो इसलिए था क्योंकि हमें फर्स्ट तो कल्चरिंग करनी थी उसको।
जब हमने बॉटल रखी, सेटअप लगाया, तो हमने उसको लेबल लगाया कि मतलब एक बॉटल में हमने 5 moina डाला, कौन सी डेट, क्या टाइम है, 1 drop मिल्क, और फिर रोज़ उसको ऑब्ज़र्व करने लगे कि मोइना कितने दिन में बढ़ता है और क्या खाता है, कैसे रहता है, तो हमें उसके बारे में पता चला।
और एक नोट्स बनाए जिसमें हम लोग डेली ऑब्जर्वेशन लिखते थे, जैसे कि हमारी फीडिंग टाइम एग्जैक्ट 9 am थी, तो उतने ही टाइम उनको फीडिंग देना और चेंजेस देखना कि आज इसके अंदर हुआ क्या है चेंज। ये फर्स्ट सेटअप पूरा बेस था सिर्फ कल्चरिंग के ऊपर। फिर हम लोगों ने
फर्स्ट सेटअप का मतलब था कि हम लोग सिर्फ मोइना कल्चर करना चाहते थे कि मोइनों को हम जिंदा कैसे रह सकते हैं। सेकंड कल्चर जो हमने किया था वो इसलिए किया था कि मोइना एक रहकर भी दे सकता है बच्चे कि नहीं।
फिर सेकंड सेटअप ना हम लोगों ने 2 July को बैठाया, जिसमें हम लोगों का ये मकसद था कि हम ये जान सके कि वो मोइने की लाइफ साइकिल कितनी है या फिर और ये भी कि वो एक वक्त में कितने बेबीज़ बॉर्न करते हैं और उनको समय कितना लगता है ये पीरियड में। इसके लिए
हमने सेकंड सेटअप लगाया जिसमें हमने 3 bottles लिए और हर एक बॉटल में एक एक मोइना डाले। सेम यही 500 ml की बॉटल ली है, उसमें 150 ml वाटर डाला, डीसी वाटर डाला और उसमें 1-1 मोइना डाले, ये देखने के लिए कि एक मोइना कितने दिन में, कितने पीरियड में बड़ा होता है और कितने बेबी बॉर्न करता है।
हाँ, ये हमारा सेटअप था और ये हमारी नोट्स है जिसमें हम लोग डेली चेंजेस लिखा करते थे कि आज इसके अंदर क्या हुआ है, उनकी तादाद बढ़ी, घटी, बड़े हुए या क्या है, जो भी हमारा डेली ऑब्जर्वेशन था वो हम इस पे लिखते थे।
जब हमने एक एक मोइना डाला तो मैंने जब डाला था तो मैंने 2 जुलाई को एक मोइना डाला बॉटल में, लेकिन वो 5 जुलाई को उसने 3 बेबीज दिए और इनका अब
और हम लोगों ने
मैंने जो बॉटल में जब स्टार्ट की थी तो पहली बॉटल में मैंने 5 मोइना डाली थी और दूसरी में भी, लेकिन 1 मोइना डाली थी, दूसरे में भी 1 मोइना डाली थी, मेरे मोइने ने 4 बेबीज बॉर्न किए
वो भी 5 डेज के अंदर, मतलब ये सारे पीरियड हुए। जब हम लोगों ने 2 जुलाई को सेटअप बिठाया और 4 जुलाई को उसके अंदर देख रहे हैं, तो पहले हम लोगों ने जो एक मोइना डाला था वो एकदम बेबी था, न्यू बॉर्न था, तो 2 दिन के अंदर उसकी थोड़ी थोड़ी साइज इम्प्रूव होने लगी और 4-5 दिन के बाद उसने बेबीज दिए, तो हमारा बेबीज का जो रेशियो था वो 3 से 10 के बीच में था, मींस कि इनके जो बॉटल्स के मोइना थे उन लोगों ने उन्होंने 4 बेबीज बॉर्न किए,
इनके 3
और नसीबुन्निसा के मोइना ने 10 बेबीज बॉर्न किए, तो हम लोगों ने एक अनुमान लगाया कि ये मोइना जो है वो 3 से लेके 10 की रेंज में बेबीज बॉर्न करते हैं।
ऑब्जर्वेशन तुम ही बोलोगी।
और हम लोगों ने ऑब्जर्व किया कि हम मोइनास को अल्टरनेटिव्स डेज में अगर फीडिंग दे रहे हैं तभी भी सरवाइव कर रहे हैं कि नहीं। हम लोग रोज हमारा शेड्यूल था कि हम रोज उनको फीडिंग करते थे, लेकिन किसी कारण एक दिन नहीं किया फीडिंग, तभी भी वो सरवाइव थे, अलाइव थे और उनकी तादाद में भी कोई चेंजेस नहीं हुए थे। इसके लिए मैंने 2 दिन और नई फीडिंग किया, तो 2 दिन नई फीडिंग करने के बाद भी वो अलाइव तो थे लेकिन उनकी जो तादाद है वो सडनली 100 से 50 पर आ गई, क्वांटिटी सॉरी।
बोलो तुम बोलो।
और मोइना रेड हो रहे थे। हम लोगों ने 8 बॉटल का सेटअप लगाया था जिसमें से 4 बॉटल ऐसी थी जिन्हें हमने खुला रखा था या फिर उनके ऊपर लाइक कॉटन लगाया था और कुछ बॉटल खुली रखी थी, तो जो बॉटल पैक थी ना वो उसके मोइनास 3 दिन के अंदर वो रेड हो गए, बहुत ज़्यादा उनके अंदर रेडनेस आ गया। तो फिर एक दिन सोचा कि ये रेड क्यों हो रहा है, फिर हम लोगों ने डिस्कस किया तो ऐसा लगा कि लाओ इसको खोल के रख देते हैं, उसे खोल के सेंटर में एक दिन रख दिए, दूसरे दिन आके देख रहे तो वो वापस अपने नेचुरल कलर में है, मतलब जैसा हम लोगों ने फर्स्ट टाइम देखा था वो वापस अपने कलर में रिपीट आ गए थे। मोइनास की जो साइज़ थी वो हम लोगों ने जब ऑब्जर्व किया, एक एक मोइना डाला तो मोइनास की साइज़ थी वो 3 दिन में बड़ी हो रही थी, मतलब वो बड़े दिख रहे थे और 4 से 5 दिन के अंदर उनके बेबी हुए। तो हम लोगों ने 8 सेटअप बिठाया था जिसमें से 6 सेटअप में एक एक मोइना थे और 2 सेटअप में मैंने 2 मोइना डाले थे, क्योंकि मुझे लग रहा था कि एक मोइनास को बेबी बॉर्न करने के लिए 2 मोइनास की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी, लेकिन मेरे तो बेबीज हुए, बाकी भी 6 बॉटल्स में बेबीज हुए वो तो सिंगल थे, तो इससे मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि वो यूनिसेक्सुअल ऑर्गेनिज्म है, मतलब कि अपने बच्चे खुद प्रोड्यूस कर सकते हैं, उन्हें दूसरे मोइना की ज़रूरत नहीं है।
बस हो गया क्वेश्चन।
और ये ग्राफ्स हैं हम लोगों के सबकी अलग अलग अपनी अपनी बॉटल्स को लेके हम लोगों ने ग्राफ बनाया था, मतलब कि ये हमारा वीकली या 10 डेज का ऑब्जर्वेशन था जिसे हमने ग्राफ में बनाया है।
हमने अपने डेटा के हिसाब से हम चारों ने अपने ग्राफ बनाए, हमारे मोइनास जो उनकी जो क्वांटिटी थी वो अलग अलग थी, उस हिसाब से हमारे मोइना डिक्रीज हुए इंक्रीज हुए, उस हिसाब से हमारा ग्राफ बना।
और बोर्ड पे जो ग्राफ है वो नसीबुन का है, इन्होंने भी एक बॉटल में एक ही मोइना डाला था और इनकी 3 सेटअप थे, तो उनका ग्राफ है एक मोइना से 100 तक उनके बच्चे बॉर्न हुए।
ये हमारे को
हम ये जानना चाहते थे कि एक मोइना हम ये जानना चाहते थे कि एक मोइना कब तक जीते, उनकी लाइफ साइकिल कितने दिन की है, लेकिन इसकी कोशिश अभी हमारी जारी है। हम अभी इस पे पूरे नतीजे पे पहुंच नहीं पाए, अभी हम इसके लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं।
इतने सारी एक्टिविटीज़ करने के बाद मतलब एक महीने से हमारा ये प्रोसेस चल रहा है, ऑब्जर्वेशन में हमारे मन में सवाल है, उनकी लाइफ साइकिल जानने के लिए हम लोगों ने एक महीना डाला, बट क्या वो उनकी बेबीज होने लगे, तो बेबीज हो रहे थे तो हमें पता नहीं चल रहा था कि हमारा जो फर्स्ट मुआयना जिन्हें हमने डाला है वो कौन सा है, तो इसके लिए अभी तक हम लोग लाइफ साइकिल उनकी नहीं पता कर सके, अभी काम चल रहा है।
दूसरा क्वेश्चन ये है हमारा कि मुआयना जब एक बार प्रोजनी हो जाता है अपने बेबीज को प्रोड्यूस करते तो क्या दोबारा भी वो कर सकता है कि नहीं?
हाँ, अगर मुआयना एक बार बेबी दे दिया है तो नेक्स्ट टाइम भी वो मुआयना बेबी दे सकता है क्या, या फिर फर्स्ट टाइम में उसकी डेथ हो जाए?
और वो कितने बार बेबीज बोर्न कर सकता है?
और हमारा लास्ट क्वेश्चन ये है कि जब ना न्यू बॉर्न जो बेबी रहता है मोइना का, क्या जो उसकी मम्मी रहती है वो खुद फीडिंग करती है, या फिर जो बैक्टीरिया बड़े जो अडल्ट मोइना रहते हैं उन्हीं की तरह वो खाते हैं?
Like, जैसे कि हम वुमेन बींग्स हैं, हमारे बेबीज होते हैं तो उनको मम्मीज फीडिंग करती है, और बाकी एनिमल्स के साथ ऐसी काओ गॉड मोइनास के साथ भी ऐसा होता है क्या कि वो सीधा अडल्ट मोइना की तरह बैक्टीरिया खा रहे हैं? ये हमारे क्वेश्चंस आए, इतने सारे प्रोसीजर में क्वेश्चंस आए, और उनका थोड़ा सा रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम कैसा है वो जानना था हमें। ये सब ये सारे सवाल हमारे इतने प्रोसीजर में हमारे सामने उठ के आए। थैंक यू सो मच। अगर आपको कोई क्वेश्चन हो तो आप एम वार्ड क्यूब ग्रुप में हमसे पूछ सकते हैं, अभी भी जस्ट ऑनलाइन। कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है, थैंक यू सो मच। अच्छा,
yes, you said some moina became red.
Yes sir.
तो उसके बारे में थोड़ा बोल दीजिएगा और एक बार।
जैसा कि हम लोगों ने 8 बॉटल का सेटअप लगाया था, सबकी साइज सेम थी 500 ml, और उसमें हाफ वाटर फिल था 250 ml, तो दो चार बॉटल उसमें ऐसी थी जो कि खुली थी, और चार बॉटल को हमने कैप लगा के रखा था ताकि वो कहीं गिर वगैरह ना जाए।
कैप मतलब कौन सा
कैप? बॉटल का
कैप,
ये वाला कैप लगा के रखे थे। तो जिसमें कैप लगी थी ना उसमें 4-5 दिन तो कोई चेंजेस नहीं हुआ, वैसे ही था जैसा कि खुली बॉटल के साथ हो रहा है वैसे ही उसके साथ था, लेकिन फिर अचानक वो रेड होना शुरू हो गए।
कितने दिन में?
एटलीस्ट 4 दिन के बाद।
तो क्या हुआ उसके बाद?
तो फिर हम लोगों ने
हमने जब देखा तो हमने अपने सेंटर पे उस कैप को हटा दिया, और वो बॉटल हमने अपने सेंटर पे रख के ही चले गए। दूसरे दिन जब हम सुबह में आए तो हमने देखे कि उसका जो रेडनेस है वो कम हो गई है, जैसे उसका पहला जैसे वो पहला दिख रहा था वैसे ही दिखने लगा था।
डिस्कस किया आपस में कि ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है, तो फिर लगा कि ऑक्सीजन की शायद कमी हो, तो फिर उसको खोल के रखा, और दूसरे दिन नेक्स्ट डे आके देखे तो फिर वो अपने चेंज कर।
ऐसे कितने बॉटल्स थे आपके पास जो रेड हो गए वापस वाइट हो गए कलरलेस हो गए?
4।
चारों बॉटल में रेड कलर था?
मोइना रेड कलर की थी।
मोइना रेड कलर का था चारों बॉटल में,
लेकिन सेम डेट में नहीं थे, अलग अलग उनकी डेट थी,
क्योंकि हम चारों अपने अपना अलग अलग किया था, तो हम जब
बट सबका 4 दिन ही है।
हाँ।
4 दिन ही है सबका,
4 से 5
नहीं, मेरा 1 वीक है, 1 हफ्ता,
1 हफ्ते के बाद इनके हुए।
तो सबके पास एक बॉटल था, 2 बॉटल थे सबके पास?
सबके पास 2 बॉटल थे।
सो मतलब 4 × 2 मतलब 8 बॉटल में 4 दिन में रेड होता है आपके? हाँ, पास इतना इन्फॉर्मेशन है।
हाँ।
और वो रेड वापस कलरलेस होता है कितने?
हाँ,
दिन में
हो जाता है।
तो वो कितने दिन में होता है?
24 आवर्स में हो जाता है
अगर आपने वो ढक्कन खोल
दिया तो।
अगर 2 बॉटल थे आपके पास करेक्ट, और एक बॉटल ओपन करते थे और एक बॉटल नहीं ओपन करते थे, क्या होता था आपको लगता है 24 घंटों में? लेट्स से
डेथ होने लगती थी।
आपके पास ऐसा डेटा है आपके पास कि डेथ हो रहा है करके?
हाँ, हाँ, हाँ,
ये ग्राफ है उमेरा के ग्राफ में, वो सीधा स्लोप नीचे गिरते हुए आ रहा है।
तो वो कितने दिन बाद होता है, वो मरना चालू कितने दिन बाद होता है?
15 दिन, मिनिमम 15 दिन.
तो 15 दिन के पहले वो जिंदा रहते हैं, फिर 15 दिन के बाद वो मरना चालू होते हैं.
हमारा पूरा कम नहीं है, हम चारों के मतलब अलग अलग.
हाँ हाँ, वही वही
वो अलग अलग है.
मैंने ऐसे 3 बॉटल बनाई थी, बनाई मोइना के, तो उसको मैंने 5 मोइना डाली और एक में 3 डाली, एक में मतलब थोड़े दिनों के बाद 5 डाली. तो ऐसा हुआ कि जो 5 मोइना और 3 मोइना जो डाली वो 200 तक इंक्रीज होते होते फिर वो लोग रेड होने शुरू होते हैं, और जब डिक्रीज होते हैं तो जल्दी जल्दी होते, लेकिन 15 दिन के बाद ही होते हैं. तो इतना हम सब लोग के इतने डेटा में आया है कि 15 दिन तक तो वो मतलब उसमें जीते हैं,
इंक्रीज होते रहते हैं,
होते रहते हैं, और 200 तक का करीब आते आते 200-250 मैक्सिमम आते आते फिर वो डिक्रीज होने लगते हैं. क्योंकि एक क्वेश्चन मेरा भी है कि छोटी बॉटल में मैं बना रही हूँ, शायद इसीलिए 15 दिन तक और इतने ही इंक्रीज हो रहे हैं, क्योंकि 3 बॉटल बनाने के बावजूद वो 15 दिन के बाद ही 200-250 तक होते होते और डिक्रीज हो रहे हैं. लेकिन मेरा नेक्स्ट सेटअप ये रहेगा कि बड़ी बॉटल यूज करूं और उसको ज़्यादा पानी डाल के देखूं, देखते हैं फिर कितना दिन और शायद उनका जीने का साइकिल हो.
और एक बॉटल में मतलब कि मोइना 15 से 20 दिन के बाद वो रेड होना शुरू हुए, जबकि वो खुला हुआ था, उसमें कैप नहीं था, और उसमें मोइना की तादाद अराउंड 1000 थी अराउंड.
सो अगर ढक्कन होता है तो रेड होना चालू होता है विद इन आफ्टर 4 डेज.
यस,
अगर ढक्कन नहीं है तो 15 दिन के बाद रेड होना चालू होता है.
नहीं, 20 डेज में हुआ था ऐसा, 15 से 20 दिन के बीच में हल्का हल्का उनके कलर चेंज हो रहे थे ना.
क्योंकि हमारे ऑब्जर्वेशन ऐसे सेम नहीं है, हमने अलग अलग ऑब्जर्व किया है,
जो अलग अलग दिन पे ऑब्जर्व किया है.
यस
या सो अब ग्राफ, जो ग्राफ निकाल के वो पोस्ट कर सकते हो व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में वगैरह, सबका अलग अलग से. सो
यस
ओके.
वाह वाह, अलग अलग किए हैं तो टोटल 19 ग्राफ्स हैं, सभी पोस्ट
किए हैं.
सो और द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट थिंग, आई थिंक यू सेड दैट 1000 मोइना तक आ गए ना आपके बॉटल पे, 250 ml पानी में.
हाँ,
कितने दिन में? 15 दिन के अंदर.
हाँ, लेकिन ना वो रेड होने लगे और उनको नहीं चेंज करी थी मैं, तो सडनली उनका डेटा
ठीक है, पर 15 दिन में, 10-15 दिन के अंदर अंदर 1000 तक आ गए ना, 1000 तक आ गए नंबर.
15 दिनों में अगर नहीं चेंज कर रहे हैं तो रेड होने के बाद और जब डिक्रीज होते हैं तो 50-60 ऐसे करके डायरेक्ट वो लोग होते होते 3 से 4 दिनों में पूरा खत्म हो जाता
है. ठीक है, पर आपका वो ग्राफ है ना ऐसा, ऊपर जाते हैं और नीचे आते हैं, तो उसका ऊपर पीक कितने टाइम पे आते हैं, पीक नंबर
200
कितने दिनों में?
15 दिनों तक तो वो लोग इंक्रीज होते रहते हैं, 200-250 मैक्सिमम अभी गिनते हैं तो उतना 300 तक का पकड़ के चले फिर भी.
250
हाँ,
250
से भी ज़्यादा हो सकते
हैं.
सबसे ज़्यादा
अराउंड 1000 हुए थे मेरे मोइना, 1 बॉटल. हाँ, 15 डेज.
हेलो, मेरे को समझ में नहीं आया कि पहले तो आप काउंट कैसे करते हैं, वो तो इतने घूमते फिरते रहते हैं तो उनको काउंट करने में तकलीफ नहीं होती, आप एक ही को दो तीन बार?
फर्स्ट तो ना हम लोग काउंट करने के लिए तो पहले तो हम लोग अनुमान लगाते थे, लेकिन अभी क्या किया, एक वीडियो बनाया जिसको लार्ज करके स्लो करके वो मोशन में वीडियोस बनाए और फिर उसके ऑफ करने के बाद वीडियोस से काउंट किया.
ओके, दैट वो बहुत अच्छा, वेरी नाइस. और मेरे को ये भी नहीं समझ में आया कि आप ये कंक्लूजन पे कैसे पहुँचे कि वो यूनिसेक्सुअल है.
क्योंकि हमने एक बॉटल पे एक ही मोइना डाला था
और वो भी बेबी था.
बेबी था, बिल्कुल बेबी.
ओके ओके,
वो बेबी हमने अकेला एक बॉटल में डाला था, उसके बाद वो 3 से 4 दिन में बढ़ा, उसके बाद उसने बेबी बॉर्न किया, तो हमें ये अंदाजा मिला.
बेबी कैसे बॉर्न किया, लाइक बेबी बॉर्न यूनिसेक्सुअल है, बेबी बॉर्न
क्योंकि उसके साथ कोई दूसरा मोइना नहीं था, वो अकेला ही था.
ओके.
तो हम इसे अंदाजा लगाए कि वो यूनिसेक्सुअल है, कि वो अपने खुद से बेबी बॉर्न कर सकता है. हमने ऐसा अनुमान लगाया.
ओके.
ना बेबी बॉर्न हुआ आपने बोला, पर वो प्रोसेस बता सकते हैं? बडिंग थी कि सेगमेंटेशन था, क्या था?
नहीं,
वो मेन बॉडी से अलग हो गया. वो देखा क्या आपने? कि खाली देखा आपने कि दो हो गए, चार हो गए?
हमने देखा कि वो वन से
सेकंड जुलाई को.
अच्छा.
सेकंड जुलाई को एक बोतल में हमने 250 ml पानी लिया, उसमें एक मोइना डाला और फिर हम लोग उसको रोज ऑब्जर्व कर रहे थे. 3rd July, 4th July तो वो थोड़ा थोड़ा बड़ा हुआ. 4th July को वो प्रोजनी हो गया, प्रेग्नेंट. और 5th July को उसने
साइज बड़ा हो गया.
हाँ, उसका साइज बड़ा होता है और वो मोटा होता है थोड़ा.
Okay.
और फिर 5th July को उसने बेबीज दिए 3.
वो नहीं, आपने वीडियो में वो कहीं नहीं दिखा कि वो बेबी कैसे सेपरेट हुआ पेरेंट से?
नहीं, वो इतना छोटा है ना कि हम उतना दूर तक ऑब्जर्व कर ही नहीं सकते.
मतलब
अभी तक नहीं किया है, करेंगे.
तो आप इसका इन्फॉर्मेशन निकाल सकते हो क्या?
नसीबुन ने किया, नसीबुन के घर पे उनकी मम्मी ने बताया था. ये हम सेंटर पे थे तो इनकी मम्मी ने बताया था. नसीबुन.
यस.
हाँ, एक्चुअली मेरी मम्मी ने मतलब के कुछ दिनों में ना क्लास में ना थोड़ा बिजी थे, इसकी वजह से ना मोइना की सारी देखभाल ना मम्मी कर रही थी. तो एक दिन एक मोइना था बस, उस बॉटल में एक ही मोइना था. और वो एक मोइना ना मम्मी जब मिल्क डालने लग गई अंदर, तो देख रही है कि वो एक मोइना ऊपर आया और कुछ ना वाइट वाइट से निकल रहे हैं उसकी बॉडी से. तो उन्होंने मुझे कॉल करके बताया कि ऐसा ऐसा हो रहा है. तो फिर मैंने इसको ऐसी ले लिया कि मिल्क डाल रहे होंगे तो लग रहा होगा.
हाँ.
बट जब मैंने घर पे आई तो देखी कि वो एक महीना से वो बहुत बारीक बारीक और काफ़ी हो गए थे.
काफ़ी हो गए. थैंक यू.
हाँ, माइक्रोस्कोप नहीं है, प्लस उस वक्त फ़ोन नहीं था, नहीं तो वीडियो बना लेते घर पे. हाँ. मम्मी कर रही थी ना.
नेक्स्ट टाइम यू कैन डू इट.
यस.
थैंक यू.
हेलो, इधर मुझे वो मैम को बताना है कि मोइना प्रोड्यूस कैसे होते हैं, कि वो बडिंग या कुछ मेथड नहीं होता. हम लोग ह्यूमंस बीइंग में जैसे होता है कि पाउच मतलब हमारे पेट फीमेल के पेट से वो बॉर्न होता है, मतलब बेबी बॉर्न होता है. वैसे मोइना के अंदर भी एक पाउच होता है, उसमें बेबीज प्रोड्यूस होते हैं और बाद में उसका मतलब जनरेशन और डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस मतलब पूरा हो जाएगा. तो वो बैग ब्लास्ट होता है, फूट जाता है. तो वो जो मदर बेबी होता है, मदर मोइना होता है, वो नहीं रहता है, उसकी डेट होती है. और बाद में जो बेबीज होते हैं वो न्यू प्रोड्यूस होते हैं. हाँ.
तो तुम लोग चार कैसे देखे, 3 बच्चे दे रहा? तो
वो उसका पाउच मतलब जो बेबी होता है उसका पाउच ब्लास्ट होता है. तो वो मतलब फीमेल रहता है मदर वाला, वो मतलब उसकी डेथ होती है. मतलब जो हमने स्टडी किया उसमें यही दिखा है.
लेकिन लेकिन
मोर नंबर आर प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम वन टाइम. सो शी वाज सेइंग एक से दो हुए, दो से चार.
मोइना क्या होता है? मोइना जो है मैं ड्रॉ करके उसे बताता हूं. तो ये मोइना है, माइक्रोस्कोप देखिए उनको ऐसा देखा. जो ये ब्रूड पाउच है उसका, तो ये ब्रूड पाउच में उसके द एग और जो बेबीज होते हैं इसमें बड़े होते हैं. फिर उसके बाद वो यहाँ से एक बेबी और ले करता है. तो उसके वजह से अब मोइना का ब्रूड पाउच जो है बस्ट नहीं होता. ऐसे कि बोला कि बोला सिंगल मोइना लिया तो उसमें दोनों दोनों सिस्टम है, सेक्सुअल और सेक्सुअल सिस्टम उसमें दोनों है. अगर हम लोग यहाँ पर इसे बोतल लिया है, इसमें एक मोइना डाले, एक मोइना का नॉर्मल जो कल्चर हमारे पास स्टॉक में से इसमें से लेके एक महीने इसमें डाला, तो ये हम लोग को नेक्स्ट डे में इसे प्रोजनीस हम लोग को मिल सकते. अगर ये प्रोजनीस इसके ये प्रोजनीस आ गए, अगर हम लोग ये सब जो प्रोजनीस इसके है तो हम लोग को नहीं मालूम कि जो हमने स्टार्टिंग में जो मोइना लिया वो मीटिंग हुआ है कि नहीं, वो हम लोग को नहीं मालूम. अगर हम लोग ये जो उसके प्रोजनी है, अगर हम लोग ऐसे ही जो इस 4 बॉटल्स अगर 4 जितने प्रोजनीस हम लोग आ गए उस सब में हम लोग ने सिर्फ एक 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 इधर और एक किधर और इसमें एक एक डाल के हम लोग ने रखा, तो हम लोग को अराउंड 3rd day में हम लोग को ये मिलता है कि ये भी एडल्ट हो जाते हैं और ये प्रोड्यूस कर देते हैं, तो इससे हम लोग बोले कि इसमें मीटिंग नहीं हो रहा है।
लेकिन मोइना मरते नहीं है।
और एक और था, आज ही हम लोग जब नाश्ता कर रहे थे तो डाइनिंग टेबल में हल्दी वाला दूध रखा था, तो माइंड में आया कि अगर इनको हल्दी वाला दूध फीडिंग करते तो क्या ये सरवाइव करेंगे, क्योंकि वो तो एंटीबायोटिकल होता है,
क्योंकि मोइना तो बैक्टीरिया खाता है, हम लोग उसको दूध डालते हैं तो दूध फटता है तो बैक्टीरिया होता है, तो मोइना वही खाता है ना, तो एंटी बैक्टीरिया मिल्क देंगे तो कैसे क्या होगा।
आज सुबह ही ये हमारे दिमाग में आया जब हम कैंटीन में बैठ के चाय पी रहे थे, नाश्ता कर रहे थे।
एक्सपेरिमेंट करके देखना है,
आगे करेंगे।
थैंक यू।
सो ये सब ओके, एक मिनट। सो मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ, लेट से आपका कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन कोई निकालना है ओके, तो आपको सर्च करना पड़ेगा वो चीज़ रेफरेंस। लेट से आप बोल रहे कि सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन होता है, सो कैसे पता करेंगे? हम नॉर्मल गूगल सर्च कर सकते हैं, और एक जो भरोसेमंद पेपर है कोई भी, या फिर भरोसेमंद जगह है जहाँ से वो इन्फॉर्मेशन लेके वो बता सकते हैं ओके। सो ऐसा इंटरनेट पे गूगल पे पढ़ के जो भरोसेमंद वेबसाइट है उसको कोट करके उसके वो इन्फॉर्मेशन दे सकते हैं उसके बारे में वो पढ़ के।
लेकिन अभी तक हम लोगों ने जितना भी डेटा कलेक्ट किया वो सब सिर्फ ऑब्जर्वेशन थे हमारे डेली के, और डिस्कशन थे सिर्फ आपस के।
हाँ, तो वो आपको कभी ना कभी तो कुछ चीजें रेक्टिफाई करनी होगी वो।
मतलब कि गूगल सर्च करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है,
नहीं तो अरुण सर से पूछेंगे ना।
गूगल सर्च। So after M-Word we have Moina working in 2-3 centers. So right now we are presenting from Elphiston Group and CHN Group. Okay, so these are third year, second year, and third year students. Okay, from CHM and Elphiston College.
So good afternoon everyone, myself Tejashree Patel, a TYBSC student of biotechnology studying in Elphiston College. Today me and my colleagues are going to present, I'm going to talk something about Moina, which we are thinking to be considered as an epigenetic model. So I'll talk about it now. So as the previous group told us about culturing, now what should be the question? Why do we need to culture Moina? That's our research question. So what we need to study basically in Moina? So I know the first slide is little Bollywood type, but through this picture, what difference do you see? I mean, most of the youngsters might have seen the movie Judwa, I hope so. So in that, Varun Dhawan was a character which were two twins, identical twins, and which were brought up by two different lifestyles. So they turn out to be little differently. One was a very studious and relaxed one, and other one was brought up in a very slum type, in very harsh environment. So he was type kind of Mawali type, we can say that. For those all who are not big such Bollywood fans, I would like to tell another example about identical twins. So we know that identical twins, I mean specifically monozygotic twins, come from the same zygote. So what makes them become so differently after a certain age if they are put up in different lifestyle? Why is it that one of the twins might get a heart attack at an age of 30, whereas the other can run a marathon at the same age? What changes that have occurred in their lifestyle that has given their genes such modification, in spite of having the same DNA that has came from the same zygote, they are brought up so differently? So what I feel is, it's not only the genes that are responsible for this change, it is the environment that has modified them or molded them into such a personality that they are brought up so differently. So my question here is, what do you mean by epigenetics? I mean, how this genes turn on or off in response to environment, that is what epigenetics studies is all about. Epigenetics is, it does not basically changes your genetic code, rather it changes, yeah. Someone raised their hand. Nothing? So, it doesn't changes the genetic code, rather it just changes the reading pattern of it. So, now there was a classical experiment conducted regarding this epigenetic studies known as the rat licking experiment, which is mentioned in the Nature of in journal Nature Neurosciences, and it was the recent research paper which I went through for this is in 2004 by Weaver. I don't remember the publication, I'm sorry, but what the research paper was is epigenetic programming through maternal inheritance. So what happens here is, some rats basically lick their pups differently. Some mothers do a lot of it, some don't do that much, but they do lick their pups. So first one, which is, this one mother, this one is a high licking mother, which licks their pup very intensely, and the other mother, it is a low licking mother which does not lick their pup that intense. But when that pup become adult, the high licking one, when it becomes adult, it also passes the same personality to their to its progeny, and it too licks very heavily, and other one doesn't lick it. So as a genetist, one would say that it might be in the genes, like perhaps the non-licking one, the low-licking one had some bad mother genes, so the pup did not, so it did not lick the pup, or it is like, and the difference in licking also showed that they had different sexual behavior, they have different lifestyle when they were upbringing, they have different sexual behavior, they have different lifestyle. The high-licking one was very less stressful in such environment, whereas the low-licking one was very stressful during the same environment. So what has made such differences in this experiment? So there was another experiment conducted to check whether is it only the genes that have come from the mother, so they are high licking and low licking, or is it something else that is going on in the picture? So the next experiment was the cross fostering experiment, in which the pups on birth were separated from their biological mother, and they were crossed, like the pup which had the low licking gene were given to high licking foster mother, and the pup which had the high licking gene was given to the low licking foster mother. And the results that came up through this experiment was, it was not the genes that we inherit from our biological mother, rather the genes that the foster mother has modified, because when the pup of the first pup, this one, when it grew and became an adult, it also licked this, it licked with the same capacity like high licking, it was high licking and it licked this pup the same way. So it had the gene of low licking, right? Because hum log ne cross kiya tha. So why did it lick its pup very highly? So there might be something that the foster mother modified, due to which that low licking pup gene modified and turned into high licking one. So this experiment showed us that there is environment plays a major role in turning some genes on and off, and turning some genes on and off, and that is passed on from generation to generation. So what we think in this experiment is that the licking of the mother sent some cascade of biochemical signals that were turned the high licking genes on of that low licking pup, and it also became the high licking one. Further, then why I'm talking so much about epigenetics? Then why our question in Moina was, when we were culturing Moina, as the previous group told, there were two types of Moina observed. One was the white one and one was the red one. But it is not that they are of two different species. They are of the same genus and same species. But why do they turn so differently? Because when they were kept in different environment, they turn out to be differently. As they told, when the oxygen level was low, they turned out to be red. And when the oxygen level was normal, they were colorless, which is their property. So why Moina to study an epigenetic model is that it is easily culturable, as we can obtain cultures within 4 to 5 days, a huge amount of culture. Second, it consists of a transparent exoskeleton. Transparent exoskeleton, as you can all see, you can see the photo which was taken in our lab itself. And it has a short lifespan, like we have not studied the entire life cycle of it, but as it is reproducing within 4 to 5 days, so we think it's a short lifespan, and easy differentiation between white and red Moina. You can see the white Moina is transparent and the red Moina has some red thing around it. So why is it turning red? So our long-term objective regarding this is to study histone remodeling of hemoglobin gene in Moina by the effect of HDAC inhibitor. I'll come back to this slide once we finish culturing. So our immediate objective we wanted to culture Moinas and obtain a huge number so that we can experiment with them. And the culturing part will be explained by my colleague Shraddha.
So we started our culturing from 6 July 2017, around 42 days. This is our picture of setup. For culturing, we first take six plastic bottles, in which we add 500 ml of dechlorinated water. For dechlorination, we simply keep water in open bucket for around 24 hours, and then each bottle we added 10 Moinas. The first picture is our A system, in which we added 2 drops of milk to maintain the normal condition. And the second picture, which is a B system, in which we added 6 drops of milks to create a hypoxic condition. The third picture is our C system. We have to determine how many days Moina takes to turn its color from red to colorless. According to our observation, we say that the Moina takes around 6 to 7 days to change its color from red to colorless, or colorless to red. Here is the difference in the Moina. In normal, first picture is the difference in Moina in normal condition and the hypoxic condition. So this is the mean graph of our bottle culture. In this, the number of Moina plotted against the number of days. As you can see, the blue line indicates the mean number of Moina in A system, which is our one drop system, and the red line indicates the mean number of Moina in B system, in which we added 6 drops of milk. So, because of our negligence, we lost our entire culture. So we again started our culturing in 2018. First we need some moina, so we brought some moina from cube and started our own culturing. So we first start bottle culture. For this we again take 6 bottles in which we added 500 ml of dechlorinated water and 10 moinas in each. But after 2 or 3 days we observed that our moina started dying. So we again added some moinas to it, but we observed same problem again. So we change entire setup started the new bottle culture. So we make a dechlorination of water for around 48 hours. Keep the water for dechlorination and for 48 hours and use this water for our bottle culture. But again, we observed the same result, so we shifted to the cup culture. So this is our setup. The first picture, which is a e-setup, in which we added 250 ml of dechlorinated water in each cup, and 5 moinas in each. In this cup, we added one drop of milk. And the second picture is which is our F system, in which we added 3 drop of milk. And we also made a rainwater culture. For this, we took 250 ml of rainwater and added 5 moinas in each cup and 1 drop of milk. So here is the mean graph of our cup culture. In this, the number of moinas plotted against the number of days and the orange line indicates the mean number of moinas in E cups. The F line indicates the mean number of moinas in F. Blue line indicates the mean number of moinas in F cup, which is a 3 drop system. And the. E system in which we added 1 drop of milk. F system in which we added a 3 drop of milk. So here is the separate graph of each cup culture with standard deviation and error bars. The error bars indicates the deviation of our values from mean values.
So we found that in the rainwater culture, which we use the 250 ml of rainwater, and the E cup cultures in which we use 1 drop of milk system, they were successful. But the F systems in which we added 3 drops of milk and 250 ml of water every day, that failed. We are still not able to get that culture of, of 6 drops in 500 ml or 3 drops in 250 ml. So we're still trying to get red moinas using milk, but the colorless one is a very successful one. We have whole lot number of moinas in the 1 drop systems.
One drop in
250 ml
in a cup.
Yeah, in a cup.
So you said that cup is better than bottle.
No, it's not better. We shifted to cups because
but
we
why?
Thought yeah.
Why?
You heard
the other people telling that bottle is fine.
Yeah, bottle was even we had a very successful bottle culture. Yeah. But I don't know, this time we tried it, we could not achieve it.
It may be some vastu problem or something.
No.
No, so why do you shift it just
so
like
we,
that?
We no. just shifted because we just shifted to cups because we heard people in Cube Lab doing it in cup cultures. So we thought, why not try once in cups?
But no, you didn't do that. Why not?
We have again started it. We did it just yesterday. The bottled ones, we have again started it yesterday. We just started it yesterday. And no, not yesterday, on Friday. Like day before yesterday. So the 2 drop system in 500 ml of water is working. But again, the 6 drops, yesterday we saw a decline from 7 moinas to around 3.
So the point is that 1 drop in 250 ml doesn't work.
It does work. 1 drop in 250 does work.
Okay. So
what is not working?
6 drop in 500 or 3 drops in 250?
It's not working means what?
It's not working means we see a very steady decline of number.
What do you mean by steady decline?
Like first because day we add around yeah there. The first day we added 5 and then on the second day we could see around 3 and by the fifth day they were not there. 0.
Do you really believe it? How many bottles you have like that?
3. We had 4 bottles and 3 cups.
Well, you can check with these people whether they are using some 3 drops of milk. Or Arif will be able to tell something. Okay, so my worries, one of the worries was this, that you just immediately changed over because of Vastu or some other reason. No, the point is that, you know, you are not taking it as a challenge.
Actually, we tried 3 replicas of the bottle culture this year too, but all the 3 replicas, the 1 drop system survived for around 4 days, but the 6 drop system...
1 drop system survived for 4 days?
4 days, yeah.
But these people are telling that they are getting it for...
1 drop.
Yes, 1 drop in 250 ml. They are all getting it for 15 days, 1,005 or some 100...
No, it survived. I mean, there was a decline. So we thought there would be some problem in dechlorination. For the second setup, we kept for dechlorination for a larger period of time. Then too, when we did the bottle culture, again there was a decline in number.
So that's the point that we are trying to say. See, you heard other people are talking about it, and it's growing and steadily growing for 15 days and huge numbers.
Even we obtained the same thing last year.
So then why, if you got it last year, why don't you just assert that if I got it last year, this time I am going to get it.
Yeah.
Instead now, of that, so you changed over that. Now, let me complete it.
Yeah.
You changed over to that and then you took rainwater. You take Ganga water. You take Sindhu water. Why do we do this sort of things? Instead of, I'm not saying that you should not take Ganges water or something. The point is that you are running away from the question. You are running away from the challenge. You can contest me. You can tell me that you are not running away. You have a very solid reason that you are doing. You can say, tell me that. But otherwise, the way that you presented it, it looked like that once you found that something is wrong, you just went into something else, then into rainwater. Now, what is this rainwater you are talking about and why?
Rainwater is just like we have this place in our college. So there was some rainwater collected in a bucket. So what we did was we took water from there and we just added Moinas into it to see what happens. It was just purely an experimental basis. We just added Moinas to it and we got a culture. So that... Nothing, it was just water. We didn't have that day we wanted to start a culture, but we didn't have dechlorinated water. So we thought, why not try the rainwater? So we just took it out of curiosity. That's it.
ये नूर सभा ने किया था रेन वाटर के साथ और उसका सवाल था कि क्या रेन वाटर में भी क्लोरीन का कुछ कॉम्बिनेशन होता है क्या तो क्योंकि वो ऑफकोर्स कंडेंस होके आ रहा है तो हम कह सकते हैं कि कहीं से सी वाटर से कहीं से क्लोरीन का है बट इसके कल्चर में वो सर्वाइव हुए तो 15 डेज
हमारे में भी हुए
और एक सवाल ये था कि क्या डे 1 और डे 2 में सेम नंबर ऑफ मोइना थे एफ सिस्टम में आपका स्टडी दिखा रहा है
या सेम थे
अच्छा तो थोड़ा सा भी इंक्रीज नहीं हुआ था
नहीं नहीं इट सेम नहीं थे लुक दिस इज द मीन ग्राफ This is the mean graph. So, so जब three system का mean graph था ये, तो we found the mean was 5. The you can see the error bars. तो उसके हिसाब से it shows the range of our values, our actual values.
Okay.
So on the second day in F system we got 6, 5 and 4.
अच्छा, तो actually ये इसलिए पूछ रहे थे हम लोग आपस में अभी बात कर रहे थे कि अगर वो day 2 पे बढ़े हैं और day 3 पे नीचे जा रहे हैं, तो क्या day 2 में हम system change कर सकते हैं? मतलब थोड़ा सा अगर population बढ़ गई है और उनके पास तो क्या हम transfer कर सकते हैं ताकि वो survive रहें? क्योंकि इन लोगों ने किया जैसे ही उनको ऐसा लगा कि वो रेड हो रहे हैं या फिर 7 दिन में उन्होंने बॉटल्स चेंज कर दिए
हमने चेंज नहीं किया बिकॉज वी वांटेड टू गेट रेड मोइनास वो हमारा एक ऑब्जेक्टिव था कि हम रेड मोइनास हमें चाहिए तो वी हैव अ कल्चर फॉर कलरलेस मोइनास एंड वी हैव अ कल्चर फॉर रेड मोइनास ऑल्सो
अच्छा तो वो डिक्रीज हो रहे हैं वो डिक्लाइन हो रहा है अगर
इधर पे वी हैड अ वेरी वेरिएबल नंबर वी हैड 6 in 1 वी हैड 9 in 1 वी हैड 4 in 1 तो इट वॉज अ वेरी वेरिएबल वन So what we did was we continued with that, and on day 3 or 4, so something like that. Yeah, on day three we had a very huge variation. The error bar shows we had a very huge variation, and day 4 they were, on day 5 they were not there.
They were not there.
Yeah.
So till day 4 we can we do something to preserve it or something?
But where
जो आपको रेड मोइना मिले थे वो कितने दिनों तक सर्वाइव थे? और
रेड मिले ही नहीं थे हमें, तब तक रेड नहीं हुए थे, इतने जल्दी रेड नहीं हुए, बिकॉज हमारा डेटा जो है व्हाट वी हैव इट टेक्स 6 days. अगर हम 6 drops ऑफ मिल्क डाल रहे हैं, टेक्स 6 days टू गेट रेड मोइनास फ्रॉम कलरलेस वंस. तो ये day 5 तक ही दे वर नॉट देयर, तो फिर 6 रेड मोइनास तो थे ही नहीं हमारे पास.
हमारे पास रेड हुए तो उसका कारण ये था कि उसकी कैप लगी हुई,
हम कैप्स नहीं लगाते हैं. व्हाट वी डिड इज ये हमारे कप सिस्टम्स हैं, तो वी हैव अ मसलिन क्लॉथ ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट. हम हाइपोक्सिया मतलब लाइक हम रेड करते हैं बाय एडिंग मोर ड्रॉप्स ऑफ मिल्क. तो वैसे करने से वी गेट 6 days में वी गेट अ रेड मोइना.
बट आपको यहाँ पर नहीं मिले, वो तो उनकी डेथ हो गई.
हाँ, तो दे डाइड, दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव एन अनसक्सेसफुल कल्चर आउट ऑफ दिस. From our previous experiments last year in 2017, what we did was this is a repeated one. इसके हमारे पास around 3 or 4 replicas हैं, and it takes around 6 to 7 days to turn red and back colorless from red to 500 ml. Okay, adding more drops of milk. Basically, by adding more drops of milk, we increase the bacteria count in the water. So that creates a condition of hypoxia, because more number of organisms, more usage of dissolved oxygen, and that leads to hypoxia. So therefore, probably the moinas turn red.
Actually, एक सवाल इसी से मुझे आ रहा है कि क्या मोइना बिना टर्न रेड बिना रेड हुए मर सकते हैं क्या, या रेड एक थोड़े से ड्यूरेशन के लिए होंगे एंड देन मर जाते होंगे, तो रेड होता है क्या, मतलब वो प्रोसेस में?
रेड होता है, रेड वाले बहुत टाइम तक रहते हैं. वी हैड अ कल्चर ऑफ रेड मोइनास फॉर अराउंड 45 days.
मैं उनकी लाइफ साइकिल के बारे में सोचने लगी थी ये डिस्कशन के वक्त, कि अगर वो धीरे धीरे मरने के इसमें जा रहे हैं, तो क्या कभी ऐसा एक वक्त, मतलब एक वक्त आया होगा जब वो रेड हुए होंगे क्या
मरने के टाइम पे? रेड
समथिंग आई एम जस्ट थिंकिंग कि लाइफ साइकिल के बारे में अगर हम उनका सोचें कुछ, तो जैसे आप कह रहे हैं कि वो रेड हुए ही नहीं, वो मर गए.
हाँ,
तो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि क्या कहीं एक पर्टिकुलर वक्त आया होगा जब वो रेड हुए होंगे?
नहीं,
क्योंकि बैक्टीरिया बढ़ रहा है,
हमारे ऑब्जर्वेशंस में नहीं हुए थे.
ओके,
तो एंड दिस ये वाला जो रेड लाइन है, दैट शोज द नंबर ऑफ रेड मोइनास. वो रेड मोइनास थे टिल 44-42 days, तो वो उतना टाइम तक रहते हैं. इट मीन्स दैट दे डोंट डाई आउट ऑफ एफ कल्चर में नहीं हुए, दैट दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम वी आर फेसिंग दिस ईयर. हाँ, कलरलेस ही मर गए,
वो बीच में कभी भी रेड नहीं
नहीं.
पर हमारे कल्चरिंग में वो रेड हो रहे थे, रेड सिग्नल था कि अब उनकी डेथ होने वाली है.
नहीं, दिस वी डिडंट फाइंड दिस,
मतलब जैसे वो रेड हो रहे थे ना. अच्छा, हो गया, सॉरी.
आपने जो F3 drop का है, उसके कितने कप्स बनाए थे?
3 cups
में सेम रिजल्ट
हुआ. पहले 3 cups, देन वी हैड और एक culture of 3 cups, and both of them died. Both, I mean, total we had 6 cups in all.
6 cups.
Yeah.
और 6 cups के result same
है. हाँ.
तो ऐसे ही कैसे हो सकता है?
That's the problem we are facing. That is why we want suggestions from all of you, so that how can we get a successful culture of.
तो 6 drop का क्या, वैसे पहले 6 drop का bottles बनाया था.
हाँ, 6 drop का culture भी we had 6 replicas, नहीं, we had 9 replicas out of that, and.
So what is
6 drops of milk in 500 ml of DC water.
What is the What is the quantity of water you have in the cup?
In the cup, it is 250 ml.
250 ml.
Yeah.
So in 250 ml, if you are putting 3 drops,
yeah,
it is equivalent to putting 6 drops
in 500.
In 500.
Yeah.
Right. So is that the calculation that you had?
Yeah, we had the same calculation.
Okay.
So yeah,
the other possibility that you could try is from 1 drop to 3 drop. You know, increase it a little progressively and try.
Yeah, that is what we are going to try.
With maybe 2 drops and
yeah,
things
yeah,
like
yeah.
that. The other possibility could be try with a diluted set of milk. Maybe your measure of the cup that it is 250 is not correct.
Probably. We could try that.
No, because you know maybe you are thinking that it is 250. If it is suppose 150 and not 250, then these 3 drops is too much.
No, we measure the water in measuring cylinders and then we add. That is our protocol which we use.
But the cups are standard cups.
Yeah, so cups are standard
once
cups.
Once you measure, that is good enough. So you don't have to go on
We thought we'll use measuring cylinders so as to, you know, because we already had failed cup culture. So what we thought was we'll take proper measurements and we'll do that. So.
And both the cups are kept in the same place. And
yeah, same place. Everything is same. All the cups are in the same place.
That they are turning into red after putting a six drops.
Yeah.
Okay, so did you find it that ki jo hypoxia ka environment create hota hai uski wajah se kaun se internal changes hote hai jiski wajah se wo
that is our long term. So we are to do only that is our project, what we are doing. So we are trying to find out why these moinas are turning red.
Did you read it any journals or
yeah, we have some literature and we have some journals which we have referred. They are this Journal of Biological Chemistry, and we have an article from Nature. They are the one is from 1997 and one is from 2001. So we have these articles, and they say that this thing could be due to DNA acetylation or DNA methylation.
He is asking that what is the reason for that pigmentation, the red pigment, red color.
They say it could be hemoglobin. In an article we read it could be, and in one we read it is hemoglobin, and they've named it. We think it is hemoglobin.
Means it is increase yeah. in number.
Yeah. In the red ones, there's an increased amount of hemoglobin.
So means hypoxia environment triggers the gene which synthesizes hemoglobin.
Like so. In hilltops when we go, we find that there that people are
having
hypoxia condition. Yeah. So what we are relating something to that.
But
the long term would be explained by this. You will get a perfect picture. I mean a rough picture of how hemoglobin is regulated.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so you are, I think I am again feeling that you are skipping the challenge. So you are saying that it could be hemoglobin. One Nature paper says it could be hemoglobin. Some other paper says that it is hemoglobin.
Yeah.
And I had to ask you, what is it according to you?
Instead
of you are committing and saying that it is, and that's why we are trying to do this, etc. So if it is hemoglobin, or if you wanted to find out it is because of hemoglobin, is there a way by which you can convincingly prove that it is hemoglobin?
Yeah, we can prove it by extraction of hemoglobin.
Tell us how do you do that? And extraction of hemoglobin means what?
For that, we will have to standardize a protocol. Till
oh,
now,
you are
we
using
don't have.
Words, you know, standardizing protocol. See, what is hemoglobin?
Hemoglobin is a protein.
Oh my God! Like any other protein.
It is a protein which gives red color. It is red color. It is an oxygen carrier in our body. It must be there in moina also.
Okay, how will you find when anybody has got an illness and somebody looks pale and the doctor suggests to do a hemoglobin test? How do you think that they will be doing, the pathology lab will be doing a hemoglobin test? Now, is it not the area that you are working on? You are talking about a red pigment. He pin you down to say that it's hemoglobin. Now, if it is hemoglobin, how will you, even on the side, you are 5-6 people, on the side, somebody wanted to say, find out, hey, is it really hemoglobin? How do we do that? And we are all biotechnology students. You must have done something to do with the hemoglobin, your hemoglobin, etc., human hemoglobin, etc. How will you do that? If you are not doing that and say that this is our long-term objective and all that, that doesn't sort of clinch the issue.
Sure.
You saw that my worry is that I am always seeing that you are running away from the scene.
Yes.
So how do you find out that this redness is because of, even these people found the redness. So you are actually addressing questions, very high questions of epigenetics and things like that. So how will you really show that, okay, this is because of hemoglobin, and the hemoglobin expression, gene expression, what you gave the explanation to him, is increased as a result of hypoxic condition. So how will you show that? First, to show that it is hemoglobin, and second, to show that the quantity of hemoglobin increases. That means qualitatively you are going to show that it is hemoglobin, quantitatively you are going to prove that the increase in hemoglobin takes place because of hypoxic condition.
What we can do is we can take moinas from the colorless ones, the colorless moinas, and we can take the red ones. We can do some extractions, and we can no wait.
Like we do in human beings, we can do differential countings, CBC, complete blood count. We can do that. If you are telling that it is hemoglobin only, then we can count the number of
RBCs. Differential count is a very difficult process. I'll tell you why, because moina is...
If you are extracting the blood, if you are isolating the blood, okay, then you can stain it and then you can check it under the microscope. Not that difficult. First year mein toh hum logo ne sikha hai na.
First year humne kiya tha, but that...
They said that they have hemoglobin. Might be it may contain some sort of blood cells, right? They are telling it. Yeah, RBC, and if it is in white colorless, so maybe it is WBCs. If they are predicting it as hemoglobin or something like that, so blood cells hoge ya hemoglobin cells hoge. But obviously some cells to hoge na uske andar. So fir y'all can count like that, stain karke, or you can view it under the microscope.
They are saying ki hemoglobin ka concentration bad raha hai. They are not saying ki maybe RBC ka concentration bad raha hai. Okay. So staining process only gives you the staining process only gives you the amount of RBCs, not the amount of hemoglobin produced.
If we know we have less RBCs or more RBCs, and then we can conclude ki usme hemoglobin concentration kitna hai ya kitna kam hai. So first we can at least predict red or white colors hai kyun. You are telling colorless and color, two colors, red color and white color. That's my point. Ki how do you know exactly that it is hemoglobin? Might be it must be containing some cells, colorless or hemoglobin containing ones.
Yeah.
Or other than hemoglobin, there might be something else. Carotenoids, xanthophytes, anything.
Okay, so what research papers for Daphnia say is that they have hemoglobin. They have hemoglobin. So what we are doing is we are trying to put that into moina, because in moina this has never been done. At least we found we found that there is hemoglobin present in Daphnia. So we are doing this in moina now.
Okay, what will you do in moina? What you said that you saw that hemoglobin is present in Daphnia. So how did they find out that hemoglobin is present in Daphnia? What's the method by which, did they count the RBC?
No,
you know,
no,
she is
no.
giving you some cues. Yeah. You can do it by RBC count, you can probably hemolyze the RBCs and look for hemoglobin content. You can run an electrophoresis and do it, you can colorimetrically, you can do it, yeah. So many things.
Okay, so.
No, that.
Okay, that's what. So I was expressing her feelings. You know.
So we'll do that. We'll do that by using.
So you have to give us some clue. How will you do it? You are six people. You
by colorimetric methods.
What do you mean by colorimetric methods?
What we'll do
this is.
This is
what I think they were making a movie of fun of me. Okay. Okay.
Okay. So we found.
One basic question. Do you think that it will have a RBC? Or do you think that hemoglobin will be always found in RBC?
No.
Or that hemoglobin can be just in hemolymph?
No. It can be.
So which other organisms will have hemoglobin? Now, this is an organism which is Daphnia, Moina, and all that is like a crocodile, is it?
No, crustacean, prawn family.
Okay, prawn. So, prawn, do you think that prawn has got hemoglobin?
Yes, it has.
Cockroach will have hemoglobin. Something else. So, we had to ask questions like this. Like she was asking a question, like our hemoglobin, she was trying to say it. So she is connecting it to hemoglobin where it is RBC. So can you count RBC? That's what she is asking. It's a very natural question, very logical question.
So hemoglobin may be present in other organisms also.
But will it be enclosed
in RBC? It can be enclosed in RBC. It's not necessary that it will be enclosed in RBC.
You can give an example that it's not enclosed in RBC in some other organism.
Cockroach.
Cockroach has got hemoglobin.
Yeah, it has hemolymph.
Hemoglobin we are talking
about. So.
If I say cockroach has got hemocyanin, it's different.
So what?
Hemocyanin.
Hemocyanin. Okay. Okay, so the point is that so many nice things like what she was trying to connect it to human beings, RBC, etc. You people, six of you, had to connect it to something else and then also look for, you can just look, type it and see that hemoglobin in Daphnia, Moina, etc., etc. So which I think you are not doing that. So all of you had to do that, and you will have to also, again, you are, I don't think that you have been conveying this message to the groups, all these what you are talking about. Otherwise somebody must have asked this question, like she would have asked this question, she would have given you an idea about RBC and stuff like that.
अच्छा सर क्रस्टेशियंस डू प्रोड्यूस हीमोग्लोबिन फॉर दे सर्वाइवल सो हाँ सो दे कैन हाँ इफ इट इज मीन्स दे कैन डू टू थिंग्स आइदर दे कैन डू अ ब्लड काउंट और इफ इट इज अ प्रोटीन नॉट अ सेल देन RBC, I mean to say that it is a cell. Huh, they can do an RBC count, or if it is just a protein, they can find some different methods to estimate those proteins. A chance, there's a chance. No? Huh, colorimeter, many different things.
Can you just suggest a colorimetric method because they are completely in C? Okay, they say that protein estimation you can do it by colorimetry. Now I don't know that.
Or you can do a protein estimation.
But you will only get a protein. No, it will be total protein you will get. You are not going to get a hemoglobin.
Not the particular hemoglobin which we'll get. We'll get the whole of the proteins in that moina.
But we can even
find out to particularly that hemoglobin protein. I mean, find out.
Very, very complex things they are talking about.
But
what? Iron exchange. What? Iron estimation, you can do it because hemoglobin has got, okay.
But we can just do the estimation of hemoglobin. There are tests for estimating hemoglobin as well. So we have a test that we studied in our first year, which is known as the Sally's method. So in that, we take the blood and we just add HCl. So the color change, basically it's the color of the hemoglobin that changes. So if it is present, then the shades become darker and you have a chart. So you compare the amount of hemoglobin present.
Okay. So there are ways by which you can do that. And if you write with this anxiety in your mails, in your messages, immediately so many people will tell you, not only from here, but also from across the country and outside. Okay. So I think that's what I'm sure that you have some more things to say, is it?
Yes,
the other people are standing there. So you concluded what you want to say.
So our junior also starting working in Moina.
This is Surekha Yadav. We wanted to know the life cycle of Moina. So we started culturing of Moina. We took 3 tubes of 100 ml in which we added 50 ml of dechlorinated water. Dechlorinated water is a water which is kept open for 24 hours to remove all the chlorine which is present in the water. Then we added 1 drop of 10 times diluted milk so that bacteria present in the water can consume it, and the bacteria and the moina can consume the bacteria. Then we added one large size moina in each of the tubes, and then we cotton plugged it. The future observation will be explained by my friend Sheila Gupta.
So what we observe and what we concluded is that on first day, on 3rd of July, we took three different test tubes in which we added three large size moinas from HBCC stock culture, which are there in our college. And on second day, on 5th of July, we observed that test tube number T2 and which name is T1, T2 and T3. The 5th of July, we observed that T2 and T3 were found dead and T1 were found alive. So, that T1 were reproduced six small size moinas, which on that day, on the same day, we separated them on the six different test tubes named as A, B, C, D, E and F. Then on 9th, we observed that the moina of the test tube F only alive, and that all the moinas were dead, found dead. And on 11th, we found that F large size moinas were produced, three small size moinas, and then 12 no changes were observed, and 13 also. And on 15, we observed that progeny became adult, means large size. And what we conclude is the large size moina takes 2 days to reproduce their small size progenies, and the progenies takes 4 days to become an large size.
आपके पास कोई फोटोग्राफ है क्या, मतलब एडल्ट मोइना और प्रोजनी का? उसने किसने टेस्ट ट्यूब्स का आपको, मतलब इसमें क्लियर नेम, कौन से टेस्ट ट्यूब्स कभी किया उसका डेली सबका ऑब्जर्वेशन आप बता रहे हो सर ओरली? हम लोग टेस्ट ट्यूब्स में कौन से टेस्ट ट्यूब में कितना प्रोजनी आया, एक प्रोजनी से एक मोइना से कितना प्रोजनी आया?
4 to 7 या मैक्सिमम वी गॉट 6 प्रोजनीस.
उसका आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है ये टेस्ट ट्यूब में कल्चर करने का?
सॉरी,
ऑब्जेक्टिव आपका क्या टेस्ट ट्यूब में कल्चर करने का?
Life cycle, to know the life cycle of moina, that how much time it takes to small size moina to mature and grow in large size moina.
So result kya hai aapka?
4 days lagta hai usko.
4 days. The 4 days mein jo first progeny hai, 4 days mein wo produce kar dega.
Adult ho jata hai.
Adult ya. Produce kabhi kare?
2 days
mein.
So total altogether 6 days lagta
hai.
6 days. So maine bhi ye matlab try kiya tha. So mere ko around ye 3rd day mein wo produce kar de raha.
हाँ तो सेकेंड डे में हम
नहीं, पहले मैंने स्टार्टिंग में एक टेस्ट ट्यूब लिया, उसमें एक प्रोजनी एक मोइना डाला, फिर वो मोइना ने प्रोड्यूस किया, जितने मोइना ने प्रोड्यूस किया उसको मैंने अलग टेस्ट ट्यूब में ट्रांसफ़र किया. तो मैंने 3rd डे में ऑब्जर्व ये किया कि मतलब सेकेंड डे में वो मोइना प्रोजनी मोइना वो एडल्ट हो रहा सेकेंड डे में, और 3rd डे में मेरे को प्रोड्यूस कर दिया वो मिल्क. तो आपका डायल्यूशन क्या, मिल्क कैसे डायल्यूशन कर रहे हो आप?
कोई
प्रोटोकॉल है ना कैसे?
वन ड्रॉप मिल्क में 9 ड्रॉप्स डीक्लोरिनेटेड वाटर डालते हैं,
टोटल 10 डाइल्यूशन.
टेस्ट ट्यूब में कितना एमएल वाटर है?
50 एमएल.
मतलब कंसंट्रेशन क्या है, कितने एमएल में कितना ड्रॉप?
500 एमएल में जैसे वन ड्रॉप होता है उसके हिसाब से हम लोगों ने डाइल्यूशन करके वन ड्रॉप में.
सो मेरा मैंने पहले क्या कहता जैसे कि मैंने उसका एक मतलब हिसाब बनाया था कि अगर 250 में वन ड्रॉप डाल रहे हैं उसका अगर हाफ लेंगे तो उसमें 1/2 रहेगा. फिर उसका मैंने ऐसा डायल्यूशन सीरियल वाइज किया था, 15 ड्रॉप तक टिल मैंने किया, मैं 15 एमएल तक किया था. तो मैंने उसमें क्या करा था, 1 ड्रॉप मिल्क प्लस 7 ड्रॉप वाटर डायल्यूट करके फिर उसका 1 ड्रॉप में फिट करा था.
But then it won't go with that. If you add 1
तो मोइना सर्वाइव हो रहा है उसमें
So you really want that one drop in 500 ml? You people want it?
What?
One drop in 500 ml is the concentration that you wanted in your...
Yes.
Yes.
My name is Amya Pawar and I'll be comparing the differences between the adult Moina and a Moina in progeny. So as we can see in the, in the adult Moina, as we can see, as Arif explained, we can see the presence of brood pouches, and in the Moina in the progeny, the brood pouch is underdeveloped. That's why there is no baby Moinas in there. And the difference, another difference is present between adult and progeny Moina. It is that the adult Moina is a little bit larger in size, around 1000 micrometer, and the Moina in progeny is around half the size or lower than that. That is roughly 500 micrometers. And both these slides contain Moina which were observed under 10x magnification. Yes, sir. And I'll also be saying the short term and the long term objectives. Our short term objective is to induce hypoxia in our Moina culture, and our long term objective is to study the epigenetics by find the sex determination by epigenetics and the study the characteristics of sexual reproduction in Moina under hypoxia conditions.
So what is that sex determination in?
Like we wanted to find out the difference between the male and the female Moina.
So are there male and female Moina? All this time these people were telling that it's only one sex or something.
Like I read a paper in which it said that in hypoxia condition Moina reproduce sexually. So we wanted to see that really in sexual reproduction.
So how much you know about that? And since you read about the paper, so do they show sexual dimorphism in the sense two different
no like it was only written I had just read like
so the point is that you are trying to study on that so you had to pursue that a little more listen
yeah I want to study on that
so then you should read something more about it or you should also quote the reference which reference you saw that which
in the end it's in the end of this presentation
tell us about it which
like
so yeah all these people I think we all the while we are talking about it that you cannot just cite references just like that.
Okay.
You know, give a one page cut and paste job. On the other hand, whatever is the relevant reference, you let us cite it in the way that people will take note of it. Like somebody was talking about, I think your group has been talking about the rat studies, beaver and mini studies. You said about the Nature paper, you said about biochemistry, journal of biochemistry or something. Or biological chemistry or something. So like that, I think we need something. That's what earlier also we were discussing about.
It was basically a paper on how to culture Moina. They were saying like how you can culture Moinas, the life cycle and all. So I was reading that paper and in that paper like it was written.
So it was only a casual reference to this?
Casual reference.
Male and female?
Yeah, casual
but
reference.
Don't you think that you had to know more about it if you are your group? So how will you go about doing that?
Like, I'll try to like induce hypoxia condition and compare.
No, the point is that at least you should know that how does a male look different from whether it looks different from a female.
I try to.
How will you differentiate a male from a female? And then only even after doing hypoxic condition whether you, and do they say that hypoxic condition induces sexual dimorphism or? So then how do you all of a sudden jump into saying that the hypoxic condition will induce sexual reproduction? how will we, what's the connection, you know? The only connection, a very nebulous connection I can see is that in an unfavorable condition, probably sexual reproduction is favored.
Okay, so like, but hypoxia is unfavorable condition, so
I'm saying that's a very nebulous sort of argument.
Okay.
But these people see that, okay, they are going on, sorry.
I feel like in unfavorable condition there might be need for variations in the species,
okay,
and
point.
That's why it might they might be reproducing sexually to increase the chances of survival of the species. That's why I think males might be produced so that sexual reproduction can be carried out.
Go to the mic.
What he means to say is that we know hypoxic conditions are stressful for them. So probably they reproduce sexually to increase the chances of survival, because sexual reproduction, we know it brings out variations. So probably to increase the chances of survival, they reproduce sexually. That's what he means to say.
So that's a good guesswork. The point is that if you are planning to do work on it, don't you think that you should be seriously looking at studies, whether studies have been done? See, we are seeing from presentation after presentation, this is the point that we are seeing, that you are thinking of studying things as if nobody in this world has done anything about it. I'm not telling about you only. Earlier also we have seen that, you know, you are not bothered about whether anybody has looked into this, whether anybody has studied it. So don't you think that's a very, very important thing that we need to do it?
Sir, actually we just started, so we were just reading papers about how to culture Moina.
How will you read paper? You know, we are worried about that, because reading paper is not like reading newspaper.
Yes, sir.
So when you say very casually that you are reading newspaper, you are reading paper, it is something like casually that she was telling that we will find out hemoglobin. Now, When I asked a question, how do you determine hemoglobin, you have problems. I think everybody has got problems, is it not?
Yes, sir.
So very easily you can say that, but if you wanted to convince an audience like this, with the people sitting at Queensland and places like that, I think it's not a very easy thing that we should be passing on things like this. So do you have any idea that how does it look like a male and female? How do they tide over this?
I just made a Google search and I just found that the male is smaller in size and it lacks the brood pouch. And that's it. Like I just.
So can you just post it?
Yes, I'll post it in the Q group.
Okay.
We've almost achieved our immediate objective for culturing. For culturing the Moinas. So now our short-term objective would be to check the concentration of dissolved oxygen present in the water with the colorless Moinas as well as with the red Moinas. So what we'll do is we'll find the DO. We have the protocol to find the dissolved oxygen. We do it in our practicals. So by that we'll find out the dissolved oxygen, and then what we'll do is we'll try to create artificial hypoxia using.
You will find out the dissolved oxygen in what sample?
In the bottles with in the water with colorless Moinas as well as in with red Moinas. So with that we'll get the concentration of oxygen at which the Moinas turn red in color. So then our long-term objective would be we'll use valproic acid.
Could I take half a minute?
Yes, sir.
So what do you think will be the dissolved oxygen concentration when it is colorless? What do you think will be the quantity of dissolved oxygen? You have any idea, because you have done it in your practical also. So what will be the, if you take a fresh water.
The normal tap water which we use, our college tap water, that has 28 milligrams per liter.
Really?
Yeah, per DL, which we have. This is what we did, our practical in our second year.
So do you believe it?
We did it, like all of us did it.
Do you believe it that it is 28 milligrams per deciliter?
Because we are 42 of us, we did it. And yeah. Our mean value was around 28 to 31.
If 30,000 colleges, everybody is doing it and they are getting dissolved oxygen of 28 milligrams per deciliter, we should be producing so many Nobel Prizes. Because you know the point is that we are doing it in the practical class without any question.
We did it, so we are doing it with the objective of finding the BOD. So we are finding the dissolved oxygen of the first day, and we keep that same water for 5 days and we check the BOD base. That is our practical. So what we'll be doing now is we'll be only finding the dissolved oxygen.
Yeah, so what do you want to say?
So,
see, 42 students doing this and you are getting 28 milligrams per deciliter. Do you really think that is true? Did you really check it with all the 42 students or something? Because you are just saying things just like that, you know. I don't think that any student who is doing it, you can correct me, you know, I am ready to go for any punishment. Anybody doing a dissolved oxygen test or a BOD test, do you think that you will be comparing all the 42 students' results? I remember cooking up results in my class, practical class.
No.
Because the teacher wants the correct answer. And I got the wrong answer, like you people are all getting wrong answer of your red moina or dying and things like that. And we cook up, because otherwise teacher will ask you to get out.
We were just...
So my point is that you are making a comment saying that all the 42 students got 28 million.
It was not 28, it was a range,
So the point is that, you know, when you are talking to an audience which is...
That's what I said, it was a range of from 28 to 35.
If I said 8 milligrams, what do you say about it?
It could be.
28 milligrams or 8 milligrams?
Probably, if you do, it can come to 8.
This is unfair. This is unfair to all of us.
So,
that means 28 milligrams and 8 milligrams, there is no difference according to you?
There is a difference.
Yeah, I am not saying that 8 milligrams is my value that I am getting. I am asking you that if somebody gets 8 milligrams, you say that it's the same. Okay, it's fine.
What we'll do is that is the protocol we are using for dissolved oxygen.
Protocol.
That is what is given to us, what we use. So we thought we'll use the same thing to check the dissolved oxygen for this also.
Fine. The point is you should use the protocol to do this dissolved oxygen. My problem is that please check whether the protocol that you are using in your college is right or not. Is being followed by the rest of the population.
No, I just wanted to know, are you understanding Arunan's concern?
Actually, no.
Okay. So there is lack of communication here. Okay. So I think should we stop here and then actually find out in a proper way exactly what it is? Or is there anyone else in the audience who wanted to say what is Arunan's concern here?
Sir? DO is dissolved oxygen and BOD is biological oxygen demand. But they are saying to, matlab dono saath mein bol rahe hain log.
Please speak in the mic, no? So.
I think. You cannot blame them for that. They said that they did dissolved oxygen test in order to determine BOD.
Yeah.
So they did dissolved oxygen before maybe 0 day and after 5 days or something. That's what the BOD protocol probably demands.
Hmm.
So what they are saying is that in the course of doing a BOD experiment, they did dissolved oxygen. So they have followed a protocol. And according to the protocol, they got 28 milligrams per deciliter or something. So that is, I think you will have to give them that stuff. They are not mixing up dissolved oxygen with BOD, no.
Mm.
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
I support you? Right.
Can we continue? Okay. So, So now, after our short-term objective, what we'll be doing is our long-term objective would be to study histone remodeling in hemoglobin gene. That means what we'll be doing is the hypothesis is the moinas are turning red in hypoxic conditions due to hemoglobin gene, and it could be due to overexpression of the hemoglobin gene in hypoxic conditions. And we're going to find the pathway by which this is happening. So if it is DNA acetylation, then we could use the HDAC and HDAC inhibitors to determine this. The HDAC inhibitor which we'll be using is valproic acid, and this is used as an HDAC inhibitor as explained by the earthworm people Manasvi and Rishikesh. So what we'll be doing is like the same way. That'll be the histone, and the and the DNA is bound to it. So the hemoglobin gene, in the beginning, the hemoglobin gene first in the bottles with colorless moinas, it is expressed, all its genes, like we have around six genes, which is there in the literature, which I'm saying. So in Daphnia, there are six genes. So it could be that all six genes are expressed in hypoxic conditions. So that is the reason they turn red in color. So in hypoxic conditions, acetyl groups bind to the histone, and the DNA is left free. So all the six genes can be transcribed and into proteins. So they seem red in color. Then what we'll be doing is we'll add HDAC inhibitor, which is the valproic acid. When we add that to the bottles with red moinas, and when we shift them back into normal conditions, they'll be remaining red in color. While in normal conditions, when we don't add HDAC inhibitor, that the bottles which are the moinas which are red in color, when shifted to normal conditions, they show a white color. They turn back to colorless. So over here, when we add HDAC inhibitor, the valproic acid, it behaves, it probably binds to the sites of HDAC, and then it inhibits the activity of HDAC, and the moinas remain red in color. That is what our long term is. Then our future perspective is to relate HIF gene and Wnt pathway. To relate HIF gene and cancer biology using moina as a model organism. That is our future. We'll do something after our long term is over, and we'll read about it. Right now we don't know the relation between the two. We'll be reading this and we'll be trying to do more about this. So
I will only request you, while reading, why don't you write also and share with others.
Sure, sir, we'll do that.
Because reading is not a very easy thing. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Apurva wanted to...
So good afternoon, everyone. Myself Apurva Satpute, and I'm from CHM College. So even I'm working on Moina. So my model organism Moina, they have already introduced you to them. So it's a water flea, small 1 millimeter in size, and it can be found in stagnant water like lakes and ponds anywhere. So the first goal was to maintain them, culture them. So for that we used to take 500 ml water bottles and add 500 ml of DC water, okay, and added 10 moinas to it and 1 drop of milk daily as a feed. And we used to plug it with cotton. So we found that in the first attempt the numbers actually decreased the second day. It might be because of our negligence, or we didn't perform it correctly, or we also didn't check the water log in the lab, so whether it was DC water or not, perfectly maintained or not. So that can be a reason. Still we continued the setup and also made another setup of same 3-3 bottles, and both the setups eventually the number increased in both the setups. So it was successful for we kept counting the numbers, and after 5 days we concluded that the objective of these setups are achieved. In the second setup, we were aiming for making them red. This time, all the other requirements are the same. Method of preparation is the same. Just we are adding 6 drops in 500 ml of DC water this time. And in this observation, we made 2 setups. And in both setups, you can see that on a 4th or 5th day, they are turning red. That is after 96 hours. Okay, and the C denotes colorless, Y yellow, and R red. The yellow doesn't mean that they are yellow in color. They are producing some red pigment, and from distance they appear to be yellow. So the objective was achieved that in 4 days they turn red in 6 drops of milk in 500 ml water. Then we wanted to check whether the color is lost again if we put them in normal oxygen. So this time we took 10 red moinas and added them in 500 ml DC water and 1 drop of milk daily. And this time we found that on the 3rd day, they start becoming colorless again. On the 3rd day, on the 2nd day, they start losing the color, and by the 3rd or 4th day, they are completely colorless back again. So this proved that the color change wasn't because of mutations, because mutations are hard to reverse back that easily, and we were able to produce colorless moinas again. So that proved that this isn't related to mutations. So this was our observations of red moinas, that they are turning eventually into red color. So this was our hypothesis. Already twice the hypothesis has been said. Just I will give a short brief. Like histones are negatively charged, and histones are positively charged because of lysine and amino acids, and DNA is positively negatively charged, so it wraps around it. And so some of the genes of hemoglobin will be wrapped around it, and they won't be able to produce hemoglobin. So these hemoglobin genes will be activated by histone acetyltransferase, as the name suggests. On the histone, they will transfer an acetyl group, which is also negative. So the negative acetyl group and the positive histone protein will react, and the DNA will be loosened up. And so that the genes are able to express now. And that's how, and all this happens under hypoxic conditions. And that's how we get red moinas. And after putting them back into normal oxygen, they are becoming colorless again. That is because of histone deacetylase. So histone deacetylase will take the acetyl group and remove it from the histone, and again the DNA will be wrapped around it, and the hemoglobin genes won't be able to express, and they will eventually turn colorless again. So another setup I tried was using sodium sulfite, which is an hypoxia inducer. What it does is it creates artificial hypoxia by reacting with the oxygen, dissolved oxygen in the medium, and converting into sodium sulfate. So as a result, the moinas will experience hypoxia and they will start becoming red. So in this set I had made three sets for different objectives. Like two were for a colorless control, in which I was adding 1 drop of milk This was made in cups because bottles weren't available at that time. So I made them in cups. Cups are of 250 ml. I'm adding 250 ml nearly DC water and 5 moinas each and adding one drop of milk for colorless. So they remained colorless for all the days. In the red control setup, I was already red moinas and adding 3 drops of milk. So in 250 ml, 3 drops of milk, just like in 500 ml, 6 drop of milk I was using. And they also remained red throughout the experiment as a control for comparing the red color change. And the two concentrations of sodium sulfide I used was 1 nanogram per liter and 10 nanogram per liter, per ml, sorry. 1 nanogram per ml and 10 nanogram per ml. So in both the concentrations on the third day of making, I found that after 48 hours, they were starting to turn red. In case of increased milk feed, it takes around 4 days. So comparatively, in just 2 days, 2 days lesser, I'm getting red moinas. So that was the one achievement or in this experiment. And also the red color was maintained for 3 days in 1 nanogram per ml. And in 10 nanogram per ml, it remained red for more 4 days. So after the color is lost, we can again add sodium sulfide and maintain them red for further experiments. So further, we wish to also try valproic acid. I haven't done it yet, but the objective will be like, in this, the histone deacetylase will take out the acetyl group and the DNA will be wound to the histone again. And that's why the gene won't be expressed and they will become colorless again. So if we add an inhibitor, so the gene will be available in the normal oxygen concentration also. And it will remain red in that condition also. So in that way, we can confirm that all these processes are happening at the cellular level, in the gene level. That's what we want to prove. So these are my future objectives. I want to redo this experiment with the sodium sulfite and check whether the same observations are, I'm getting them again or not. Another objective I'm adding now is finding out dissolved oxygen concentration, and so that I can confirm that this is because of hypoxia and no other factor is involved, and also hemoglobin estimation also, that how we will estimate hemoglobin. And a short-term goal will be a valproic acid experiment, finding out using valproic acid experiment how does the inhibition take place or not, or what are the observations for it. And long-term will be complete study of the epigenetical mechanism. Like, is there anything other things involved, or are there another mechanisms involved in this experiment? Yeah. Thank you. And these are my comments.
They may be wanting to ask a question. Why don't you ask a question to him?
So, in the first slide, you wrote that they are phototactic in nature.
Yeah.
Mic. Use mic. Because people are watching.
So, in the first slide, you wrote that it is phototactic in nature. Moina photo. How do you know they are phototactic?
Phototactic means they are attractive to light, and that's the... we were using that property to count them. Means we use flashlights and we flash them at the bottle and they get attracted to it. So it is easier to count them. So yeah, that's the property. We can easily check that out by using a flashlight.
In the next, further you told that when it is colorless, the gene is tightly packed around it. So
Hemoglobin is not present
in colorless one.
There are multiple genes. Some of them are expressing while some are not. So which are expressing hemoglobin, they aren't producing hemoglobin enough to produce the red color. So when all the genes are available for expression, the moina turns red.
You mean to say all the genes produce the whole of hemoglobin?
Yeah, means whatever the amount of hemoglobin they are
amount
producing.
Do you mean to say that some subunits are produced or all of them?
Not subunits. I don't know about the subunits.
वो पूछ रही हूँ।
मेरा सवाल आपसे था, आपने हाँ मतलब इस रेड मोइना का था, आप बता सकते हैं ज़रा कि आपके जो रेड मोइना थे वो कितने दिन जिंदा रहे?
हाँ 42 डेज तक का हमारे पास ग्राफ है एंड नंबर हमेशा इंक्रीज ही हुआ था। सो जिंदा रहे, हमने एक एक मोइना के साथ नहीं किया, व्हाट वी डिड वाज हमने एक साथ 10-15 ऐड किए थे और जब तक वो रेड टर्न हुए थे ऑलरेडी उसमें 75-80 हो चुके थे एंड वो बाय द सेवेंथ डे सब रेड हो गए थे एंड उसके बाद हमने सिर्फ इंक्रीज ही देखा था नंबर में।
मीन्स आपने बहुत सारे मोइना जो थे वो रेड हो गए, तो आप कुछ ऐसा प्रोसेस उनके साथ करी थी, कुछ निकाल के उनको अलग करी थी?
नहीं, हम लोग लाइफ साइकिल पे उस टाइम पे स्टडी नहीं कर रहे थे तो हमने ऐसा कुछ किया नहीं था, हम बस उसको रेड ले रहे थे, हम उनको
बस अब रेड ले रहे थे। एक्चुअली हमने जो ऐसा करा ना तो जो हमारे रेड हो रहे थे तो वो मिनिमम ना 2 डेज ना जिंदा रहते थे, उसके बाद से अगर वो उनकी तादाद 100 में है तो वो डायरेक्ट 50 हो जाती थी, फिर ऐसे करके उनकी पूरी डेथ हो जाती थी।
ओके
एक्चुअली वी इवन गॉट 400 रेड मोइनास इन वन बॉटल।
हां वी हैव गॉट दैट,
दैट्स द हाईएस्ट
जो नहीं हाईएस्ट इज 550 एंड वी डिवाइडेड इन देम इनटू 2 बॉटल्स, तो हम लोग का काउंट हमेशा बढ़ा ही था।
ओके
हाँ रेड कलर में, बिकॉज हमने उनका कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कभी चेंज नहीं किया था, हमने सेम हम 6 डेज ऑफ मिल्क एवरी डे डालते ही थे हमेशा। वो सिस्टम वह हमने वैसा बनाया था कि वो चेंज ना हो, नहीं हमने बॉटल्स में रखा था 1 लीटर बॉटल्स, नहीं कैप नहीं, हम उसको कॉटन से प्लग करते हैं।
और फीड 1 ड्रॉप मिल्क?
नहीं 6 ड्रॉप मिल्क रेड वाले के लिए, रेड के लिए 500 ml में हम 6 ड्रॉप मिल्क ऐड करते हैं।
You guys, मतलब रेड हुए थे तो उसके बॉटल और पानी चेंज किए थे
क्या? नहीं हमने चेंज नहीं किए,
सेम बॉटल
सेम पानी और सेम बॉटल, सिर्फ हम स्प्लिट किए थे बाद में, वो सेम रखा था हमने और कुछ नहीं, उसका सिस्टम सेम था।
यू गाइस यूज्ड डीसी वाटर एम आई
राइट? या वी यूज्ड
डीसी। एंड यू गाइस मतलब आपने भी डीसी वाटर यूज, मतलब नॉर्मल वाटर के साथ ट्राई किया था आपने ऐसा?
तो उन लोगों ने
टैप वाटर या आई मीन लोकल बीएमसी वाटर,
नॉर्मल बीएमसी वाटर से अगर हमने एक किया था उसमें वी केप्ट फॉर डीक्लोरिनेशन फॉर ओनली 15 आवर्स एंड वी सॉ द मोइनास डेड द नेक्स्ट डे।
ओके सो यू मीन द आयन कंसंट्रेशन एंड द पीएच
बैक्टीरिया कंसंट्रेशन प्रोबब्ली बिकॉज़ द वाटर व्हिच वी गेट इज क्लोरिनेटेड राइट?
ओके थैंक
यू। ओके सो आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल द नेक्स्ट प्रेजेंटेशन व्हिच या थैंक्स। I would like to call next presentation from the IWSA, that is Indian Women Science Association, which is a topic is Learning Garden, a platform to question and understand the whys and hows of the nature. So we have with us Vijaya Chakravarti, that is from ecologist, she's an ecologist and landscaper, Tripta Tiwari, she's a chemist and a naturalist, and they are actually they have the center from in Vashi, Navi Mumbai. So I will just take 1 minute to read the abstract. The abstract is learning is a continuous process. Learning about the environment is in turn a dynamic, interactive, and accelerating experience. This requires monitoring our surroundings for the natural changes that occur and questioning the continuous presentations of nature. In a city, it is often a challenge to find a green spot with a variety of flora and fauna, which could be monitored to enjoy and understand the treasures of nature. At the Indian Women Scientists Association, Vashi, we have initiated a learning garden. In this garden, we have provided learning opportunities about art, botany, chemistry, geography, geology, history, mathematics, physics, medicine, sociology, and zoology, etc. Plants are placed in defined zones as representative of these subjects. It is dynamic platform on which any cube member can monitor the changes and question the observations to provide an in-depth learning experience. In this presentation, we will provide example of how USA's learning garden can broaden our horizon and can be stimulating experience to understand the wonders of nature. So yeah, just I will like.
Thank you. We're really delighted to be here today with you all. We're delighted to be here with you all today, sharing in the learnings that are taking place here. I'm Vijaya, and this is Tripta, and Suparna, and Madhu. We are all from the Indian Women Scientists Association. Learning, as you know, is a continuous process, you know, and especially learning from the environment is such a dynamic thing. It's very interactive, you know. Every day in the morning, you see something new. Suddenly, before the rains, you see the quail, and that is a bioindicator. They say 45 days before the monsoon starts, the amaltas, the laburnum, the Indian laburnum starts blooming. I mean, these are things which we can study. They say the neem tree, if it is in full flush, it indicates drought. So today, y'all were talking about the experiments which you have done. And we at IFSA are setting up a lab for you to come and experiment and to learn from it. You know, we have divided the garden. You know, we don't have much space, as Dr. Arunan has seen, but we have created small mini landscapes. The different, you know, where we study bromelides. You know what bromelides are? Bromelides have their own water tank. So inside this cup, there is water. And in the water, there is a whole ecosystem, which you all can come and study. And then we have tried to, teach learning through a sensory method. So it's basically a sensory garden. So the sights, the sounds, the smells, you know, are very intoxicating. And learning takes place best in a sensory setting. Because remember, at IFSA, we have little children from the age of 3 till, you know, post-grads. We have these BRNS lectures. We have, different things where people from IITs, from different schools and colleges come over. And I would like to invite CUBE to come and experiment with us and learn from us. So we also have, you know, gardens which depict the different bioregional areas of India and the world. We have the Western Ghats. So we have put plants from the Western Ghats over there. And you know, as you know, Western Ghats have been declared as the hottest of the hot spots of the world, biodiversity hotspots of the world. And then if you see, most of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra, Telangana are in the Deccan Peninsula. You know, this is a very fragile ecosystem, a very neglected ecosystem. So this is where one can study how plants are surviving with hardly any soil. And in certain areas, it's very, very arid too. And then, of course, the coastal. We come from the coastal region, Mumbai, Navi Mumbai. And then we've also shown the rainforest. You know, in one place, we just left plants. And we forgot all about it. And we neglected it. And then soon we found that these trees, you know, plants had grown up because they were from the rainforest areas. There was a fishtail palm from the Western Ghats, you know, the rainforest of the Western Ghats. There were some plants from the Amazon area, the philodendron. Sripta, can you show the philodendron, please? From the rainforest. So every inch of space was occupied by the plants. So we had, because of these roots, it clings to the tree. So we had a tree from Southeast Asia, the Peltophorum, which all of you all must be familiar with the yellow flowers. And we had these philodendrons growing on it. Then we had ferns at the bottom. The fishtail palm took root there. We had a brassia. So in just a couple of square feet, we had a whole rainforest ecosystem. And there was no competition, but it was rather a cooperation. Now, you know, I've seen Professor Arunan asking us a lot of questions. Every time we put something on the CUBE, immediately he'll say why and how and when. So I said, let me, you know, learn from him. So all of you all must be familiar with the Chini Gulab, China Rose. It's very familiar. In fact, I've seen this growing on the shingle in IFSA. You know, we have sand over there. And it was thriving. course, here we put it in the sensory garden because it's got a lovely, shocking pink color, right? But I was wondering, are there other uses for it besides the horticultural use? You know, there is a similar plant from the same Pochilaka family called Gola Bhaji, which Mahatma Gandhi used to eat every day as a salad because it was packed with micronutrients. So can we make color from this? Can we make dyes? Yeah, this is what Mahatma Gandhi used to eat every day as a salad. And during World War I, there was scurvy among the soldiers. So one of the generals, you know, he deputed 4 soldiers to forage for this plant. And they found that the scurvy decreased and the people were, the soldiers' health had improved, right? So probably does it, yeah, it's from the same family. So does it have any medicinal uses? Can it be used as food? What happens when people get lost? I hear that in Australia, people get lost all the time. The commando training, does it have other uses? Now, this is very strange. Of course, it is mixed up. The center one is actually in IFSA. There's a mix-up over here in the captions. One crotalaria, in Marathi, you call it kulkula, dingla. It makes a lot of sound. This is one we would like to present. If you all can plant it over here. So we planted one in Goregaon, in one of the gardens we did there. And it was packed with butterflies. Yeah. And we planted another in Alibag. And that also had dozens of butterflies on it. But we planted one at IFSA. And so far, we have not seen a single one. Why? Why did they give a miss to IFSA? We have other butterflies coming, other plants we have with exoras and kadi patta, custard apple. We have butterflies, but none on this crotalaria plant. So this is something, this is a sitafal, you know, custard apple. This is also a very good organic pesticide. Y'all could study. We have Suparna here who is, in, you know, got about hundreds of trees. We have a small arboretum all in pots. So y'all can come, y'all can study. This, I think we posted once to Professor Arunan about the Jatropha. We have 4 variety species of Jatrophas in IFSA. Yeah, this is one of them, Jatropha. But only on this, we saw the jewel bug, you know, breeding. On the others, we had one, you know, which Jatropha carcass. That is a biofuel plant. There's one, the Gossypilla, which grows along the coast. You'll find plenty of it in Bombay. Then we had one, another one, Integrima, which has got lovely flowers with plenty of butterflies. But we had only one where the jewel bug had come. So this is something, you know, we would like you to tell us. Why? Why only this? Is it because the leaves are big? Or the flowers are pretty? The others are prettier? You know? So this is something we would like to know. These are the questions we are asking you. All of you all know about hydrangea. It indicates the pH level of soil, right? When it is alkaline, it is pink. And when it is soil is acidic, it is blue. So we can change the colors by adding more alkaline thing. Yeah. But we have another plant called the 4 o'clock. Do you know 4 o'clock? Yeah, you know, it blooms at 4 in the evening. I don't know why. Maybe you can tell us why. But a very funny part of this is on one stem, you will find flowers of different colors. Even one flower will have different colors on it. But why? Why is this so? Then we have another plant. We have accidentally planted it in the creeper section. Actually, it is called Brunfelsia, or yesterday, today, and tomorrow. You know, the flowers vary in color. It is dark blue, almost purple, then it becomes light blue, then it becomes white. So we want you all to tell us, come to IFSA. We are setting up a big lab for all of you to come and study at Cube IFSA. So please do join us. Yeah. So these are photo, you know, this is a very funny thing is happening. Our thing was children. We wanted to study about. Did I skip anything? No, I didn't skip. So, you know, we actually wanted children to study, children to learn. But in the process, you know, an accidental, unexpected outcome happened. And we found the people, these are all our team. We started getting bonding, you know, bonded together. We started learning more and we developed team spirit. And, you know, there were a lot of changes. Of course, that is not a topic for today, but this is what we learned, you know, the psychological and sociological aspects of gardening. That's it. Thank you very much. And thank you for giving us this lovely opportunity. And we also enjoyed sharing in today's learning all about the Moina. Thank you very much.
That Jatropha, you said.
Oh. Hello. I was not knowing much about gardening, but in this laboratory of a gardening garden, we call this a laboratory. And many of you must be knowing about lemongrass. Yes. And the chemical also, Professor Arnan will tell the chemical in it. But another lemongrass-like plant is coming, and the nurseries are selling it with a name that is a trade name of Odomos. Odomos, yes? And that Odomos plant looks exactly like lemongrass. Lemongrass everybody uses in the tea, wo chai banane mein use karte na. But lemongrass is edible, like you make tea with it and drink. But the other one which looks exactly like it and is Odomos, called Odomos, is used for repelling mosquitoes. And that is not edible. So what is the difference? Please find out, cube people, find out and let me know. Another thing, all these deers, I thought, cinnamon. Here we have bay leaves, and a cinnamon branch of a cinnamon tree. Okay, these are Odomos and lemongrass. And here we have cinnamon and cinnamon is also known as bay leaf, tejpatta and dalchini. All these years I thought that tejpatta ka plant ka bark is dalchini. That's what I was under the impression. Both look alike. And now after under her gardening laboratory, I came to know that these two plants are entirely different. But they look alike, their leaves are identical. What are the differences? Few people have to tell me. Find out and tell me, Google it and tell me, yes. What are the chemical differences?
You're talking about red moinas. We find that many plants have new leaves which... No, you continue. We have new leaves which are red in color. So you want to know why? If you see the people, you see that the new leaves of the people are red in color and then they slowly turn green. So this is a Christina and this is Dalchini. You see the new leaves. Even the mango, the new leaves of the mango are also rust colored.
Yeah, afterwards. Yes, afterwards they change their color. What is the reason? Due to sunlight and all that photosynthesis, all those processes you must be knowing. But we can do a lot many experiments. And here we started learning the life cycle. As you are learning, trying to learn the life cycle of Moina, we are learning life cycle of butterfly. And variety of butterflies and how much time that those slides are missing here, those photographs that we found out that how much time we are still experimenting. It will take from the egg to the pupal stage of the butterfly and then from the pupa, how much time it take, what part of the butterfly comes out first from the pupa stage, whether the head and then the antennae, then one wing, then the other wing. And for different butterflies, different, it takes different timing. So all these factors, all these things you can learn in our gardening laboratory. That's all.
So we invite all of you to please come to that.
Sure.
Thank you.
So some questions. So I think I will start with, you said about, I think, Jatropha. I think it attracts butterflies, you said?
No, the jewel bug.
Oh, I see, okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that is the jewel bug. Yeah. Okay, so do the butterflies come there for laying eggs or feeding the...
We found the jewel bug, both the adults were there as well as the larvae. Oh. The that was you know, something quite
okay. So that's a good possibility that they will be coming for laying eggs. And yes. Would they eat? Would they finish the leaves?
Yes.
Okay.
They were also, you know, taking the sap. We found that, you know, in certain places the stem was getting weak.
You mean the adults?
Yeah, adults. Yes, adults. Huh?
Yeah, and the butterfly find the plant of the category on which the caterpillar to lay eggs on which the caterpillar can feed. Like we were discussing about that curry patta leaves being eaten away and all that. That is because caterpillar of that particular butterfly feeds on curry patta. And there are no flowers still, it will come and lay eggs over there so that its newborn will come and feed, will survive over it. If it doesn't finish all the leaves.
So that's an interesting question. In the sense, the same butterfly will go to, for its food, it will go to, for its food, it will go to another plant.
Yes, for and to for get its nectar, to get its food to the different
its
plant.
Egg laying, it will be go. It will go to a plant where its caterpillar will be feeding on.
Yes.
Like the kadipata.
Yes, yes. Stuff. And mainly they smell the alkaloid present in the leaf to lay their eggs. Hmm? And so that its caterpillar will feed on those leaves and will grow faster. Mm-hmm. And the leaves are softer and some particular kind of nutrition present in them, they can
so
grow.
So which is this butterfly that is on this jewel?
That is not a butterfly.
It's a moth, is it?
No, it is a bug.
It's a bug?
A jewel bug the Jatropha. On the crotal area, it's very strange.
Okay, okay.
You have a lot of male butterflies. Especially from the tiger family, coming onto this crotal area to suck the sap. There are alkaloids in it. So this is for propagation, for reproduction. It helps them, the alkaloid. And also as a defense mechanism. Mm-hmm. When they absorb the larvae, when it eats, they develop a chemical which will ward off the predators. And also the males eat. That's why you find a lot of butterflies on crotal areas. I've seen hundreds of butterflies on crotal areas.
I remember that photograph that you sent.
Yes,
but
that had hardly any. But
you should send more of this and so that we can spread around with.
We'll do that.
The plant, crotal area.
Yeah, we'd like to give it.
Jay, yeah. There's a gift that's coming to you.
Yes, we'll give it to Jay. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Anybody, how many of you are from New Bombay? Nobody from New Bombay. What is this? One. Okay, so that person will be inviting everybody to that place.
Oh, you are inviting, of course.
Okay, so now we will be breaking for the snacks and tea. So we will just take for 10 minutes and we will return back again because we want to continue. Okay, yeah. Yeah, break.